big time movie star, recurring artist, very funny comedian. Jamie Foxx is on his way out.
Hey, anybody want some of this?
Jamie Foxx is one of the baddest.
Because brothers can't never give you your full prop.
I told Jamie he was going to be famous.
Jamie Foxx, you could act.
Jamie Foxx, he's got the voice, he's got the looks, he's got everything, and it's unbelievable.
We like the party. Who likes the party, man?
Listen, Lord.
Dramatic actor.
We've been blessed with the opportunities to have a drama lane.
Comedian with hits on the big and small screen.
It's hard to believe the guy on the screen is the same goofball I see in the comic book.
I'm the innovator and the motivator, the originator of this stuff.
And a chart-topping sexy singer.
May I say it, baby, you have the voice of an angel.
Winning actor, he's a multi-platinum recording artist,
Grammy-nominated singer, a critic, stand-up comic.
So you're just taking over show business, apparently, huh?
You know, I'm doing my best.
And the Oscar goes to...
Jamie Foxx!
Jamie Foxx! Please welcome Jamie Foxx!
Jamie Foxx!
Jamie Foxx!
The next president of the United States, Jamie Foxx!
Yeah, say that one more time!
Once again, Jamie Foxx, comedy legend, Jamie Foxx!
Hey, you know what? Oh, I'm gonna make it do what I do.
Hysterical! Olivia Newton-John. Yo, it's Friday,
yes.
The Foxhole.
Prove it.
The greatest day in the history of radio.
History.
Oh, yeah. Goes on down
break
here.
It down like it's this. Come on.
Down.
Wow. Who the hell is this?
What?
Paging me at 5:46 in the morning. Crack of dawn and now I'm yawning. Wipe the cold out my eye. See who's this paging me and why. It's my brother Pop from the barbershop. Told me he was in the gambling spot. Heard your intricate plot. The brothers want to stick me like fly paper neighbor. Slow down, mother. Remember them cans up the hill up in Brownsville. That you wrote dice with. Smug lunch, you got nice wit. Yes, my brother Fame up in Prospect. Nah, that's my brother Nah, love. What now? I didn't say him. It's Scooby to some brothers that you knew from back when you were clocking minor figures. Now they heard you blowing up like nitro. And they want to stick the knife through your windpipe. So, thank Fame for warning you. Now I'm warning you. I got the mat. Brother, tell me what you want to do.
Damn.
Why they want to stick me from my paper?
Oh, damn.
Why they want to stick me from my paper?
Oh, damn.
Why?
Eddie Long in the paper. Damn. The best of Eddie Long is in the paper.
Get the cologne out of my
mouth. Man, what's up, Foxhole?
Hey,
what's going on with
crackin'.
Other than the crack in your ass.
Cologne.
You know what's crazy? I've been saying that for years. And everybody thought that
what?
Was a joke, but I was dead serious
you
about
ain't
that.
Never said that.
I've been saying that since the 90s, Speedy.
Fox,
I've been saying that since you was 187 pounds.
Wow.
Oh, you are you saying that Fox bit that from you?
No. Fox didn't bite that. We would say it together. We all had like
little phrases. You was in jail.
He does have the teeth for
it. You was in jail in 87, boy.
No. I said Fox. She's my Fox. I met you back in 95, Speedy. We was kicking that around.
So Jamie didn't steal that from you. You scared to put it out there, huh?
Wow.
You backpedaled. All I saw was you falling back. You look like Revis.
Well, we'll know when you working at the unemployment office next week what happened, what you should have stole. Nah, we just friends. We all just had that phrase. It ain't about who stole it.
Well, okay. I don't know, Johnny Mac.
I hope you won't be leading the Million Man March anytime soon.
All right, Arnaz J.
Black.
Wow. Whatever you want to say, Arnaz J.
Hysterical.
Is that like, do you think?
How would that be Arnaz J? Anyway, we're going to do a quick roll call. Everybody know who's in the house. The beautiful, the curvaceous.
Oh.
Wearing her real hair.
Nah, I went back to the
people. I want to play.
Claudia Jordan. Hey, what's up?
C-Murder.
Hey, C-Murder in the house.
What's going on, Claudia? You're looking great.
Thank you very much. Great.
You played.
Yeah, you look nice. Monday night, you look nice.
I want to play.
You know what? Louis Dix was such an asshole this weekend on the softball
game. We're going to get into that right after the roll call. We'll get right into that right after the roll call. Over here is my man, 10 grand player, mean shortstopper. Now he's on first base.
Good. Well, evidently wasn't that good at shortstop.
Happy Foxhole Friday, C-Murder, Johnny Mac.
Thank
this
you.
Is TDP, still Mr. Holy Water. 1, 2, 3 knots.
Baby! Mr. Holy Wild. Over here, my man, 10 grand, sporting a brand new haircut.
Go ahead.
It's your boy, Speedy.
877.
Just want to make sure all the ladies know that your boy's in the house.
Oh, God.
Hey, Speedy, if that works for you, I'm a roll with that. If that works for you.
What do you mean, does it work for me? Yeah.
Don't use the voice on me.
Speedy,
you felt yourself coming.
There'll be no pillow talking on this end. I can hear that right now.
And he brought one of his tribe to the show today. One of his little babies. Sure. Two of his
and
tribe.
I have to give a shout out. Members. My youngest son got his first haircut. He's 6, but he got his first haircut today.
Wow.
I didn't recognize him when he came out.
So who paid for all the other ones?
government.
Wow. Aw, Speedy.
Over here, we got my girl, the nice new haircut.
Love it.
That is short. You got many styles with it.
Look like Dorothy Hamill.
I'll give it a 10. I give it a 10. OG poetess.
Rehab every day.
Now, can we go back to the smoke weed? Could you stop? I don't know. I get confused.
I'm drinking weed soda now.
Wow.
Weed soda?
Is that such a thing? Yeah, they even have grape flavor. You know how we like grape.
So do the seeds be at the bottom of it?
So you drinking Chronic and Coke?
No pulp, no seeds.
Wow, Paulus.
Do you like your soda? That's what I'm saying.
I'm a little bit concerned, Paulus.
Do you put the whole can in the Philly blunt?
No.
Your thighs are showing, too. I'm going to tell you. Your thighs.
No kidding.
You got them Robert Newhouse thighs.
That's
wow. Earl Campbell.
Who's that? Oh, okay.
The young Mr. T look.
Boys got thighs. Fellas, if you ain't seen
poetry. Got more thighs than Popeye.
Is this another love connection?
I'll take the white meat.
Poetess, love connection, maybe? Which one? All three of them.
Oh, poetess, get it.
Oh, Foxhole Train.
Yo, over here we got.
And pour some more soda.
Over here we got, last but not least, my man. He pissed a horrible game.
He did.
He walked 8 people.
The white cut.
Bitter pitcher.
Okay.
Bitter pitcher.
Now we have to say I had a bad game.
We got to introduce you first. Okay. We had to take you out. This the only person that had a reliever in a softball game. He couldn't go the whole night. My man, 10 grand.
I'm still laughing at what Speedy said, Robert Newhouse.
Focus.
Louis Dex.
Fistic.
In your mouth.
Fistic now.
Don't get a timeout here, too.
Can I ask the question, Louis? When the white girl switched plates and went to the other side and you still couldn't strike her out.
What's wrong, Lil Dex?
Listen, evidently, it was a double header. It was hot as I don't know what out
there. It was hot for us,
and
too.
I was focused. I was a little over-focused.
Yeah, you was over-focused.
Yes.
And I couldn't hit the plate.
But we won.
And then we're in the championship game. And I told y'all, if y'all give me that lead, I'll get those last two outs in the first game.
Let's talk about the baseball game.
He went nuts during the game.
There seemed to be a little problem going on.
It was.
You struck out every time.
Yeah, you got stuff. Who did? Out, Louis.
You struck out twice in one game.
No, yeah, I did.
Sammy Soda.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
A grown man should never strike out Soda.
Not twice.
Okay.
Listen. And I mean swinging. You wasn't even looking. You swung and hit molecules.
Steve Gravy. I'm telling you, you'd be a great ceiling fan.
He did cool me off after he made me high.
I had a bad game.
Go to the bad game.
But it was the first bad game I had.
No.
Not really.
Well, you're usually a decent pitcher, but you were really intense.
Remember the
white girl that wanted to switch with me, she's like, Claudia, you go in now. She gave me a glove and then lose. Where you going? You get out.
Yes,
you did.
I respect the
you
didn't
even stick her right there. No, I said, Speedy, get your outfield together. And that's what I said. And then Claudia, I was like,
Claudia was crying.
Claudia
was crying.
But no, it goes back.
Did you see me crying?
Yes,
I didn't see her crying.
You didn't see me crying.
Yeah, because Reno was trying to rap her.
It was one of them lifetime cries.
First of all, Reno
was a weak cry.
I want to be by myself.
It was a weak cry.
What happens, I said, we have an outfield, and our Speedy's in one part of the outfield, and that hurts us.
Wow.
So, I mean, come on, Speedy. You've been from first to outfield.
How do you get on me when you
first? But, Speedy, you are great at retrieving Gatorade, though. Yeah. The way you get the Gatorade for the real players.
Ice, no ice. Who wants it? Ice, no ice.
But Lewis
the way you get the Gatorade is phenomenal.
Lewis,
get it right here.
I did not approach it. I should have said there's another way that we could figure this out. But what I said was, Claudia, you need to go back over there. You're a back catcher. We rotate the back.
Is that how you said it to me?
I said, Claudia.
You said it so foul that Jamie put you on time and made your ass sit down.
I said, Claudia.
No, he did that because you started getting emotional.
No, I didn't.
Be honest.
I was emotional on anything.
Can I be honest?
Be honest.
I don't even know what happened.
I went for a walk. I had some other things going on.
Reno was instigating because he was trying to hit.
Speedy can recall because an elephant never forgets. What happened, Speedy?
Tell
Lewis told
in
Claudia.
In pachyderm news.
Lewis told Claudia, go back in the dugout. You came late. You are not in the outfield.
And it's
Claudia, be quiet. Claudia starts crying. Fox came out and said, I'm never coming here again. This nigga made Claudia cry. And I said, Claudia, come on out in the field.
So Claudia started crying. There's no crying in baseball.
Really?
She started crying on the
field. I did not cry on the field.
Lewis came at her wrong.
Lewis was overbearing.
He was very overbearing.
But I had some other things. Like, Reno was talking about.
So they use your eyes as a sprinkler?
It was a whole bunch of other stuff going on.
Yeah, because her cat died 2 months ago.
The cat. I'm over the cat. I put the cat to
sleep. She starts spotting in the third inning.
Did you see her booty shorts, though?
She was in the booty shorts.
Thank you, Claudia.
With makeup.
But you know what? You look great at the baseball game, but what you wore Monday to the conga room, priceless.
Thank you.
Yes. Luxurious.
I laid on the floor so I can look up those shorts. I got stepped on the forehead and my arm got crushed.
I thought you lost your crack pipe.
Well, we are in the championship. Let's get it right.
Speaking of perverts, the pilot of a private plane,
hysterical,
tops no bottoms air.
Wow.
Who flew around all Bishop Longfellow's.
Speaking of perverts.
First name Johnny, last name Mac, middle name Motherfucker. And when you see him say that, here it goes.
Johnny motherfucking Mac. And I'm going to say this with sincerity. Take the bishop off his name.
Okay.
He said sincerity.
Who's
sincerity.
Oh, okay.
you know as a stripper.
I thought he said sincerity.
He said Saturday and Sunday.
Sincerity, I'm just saying.
Hey, I run my syllable together.
Yeah.
And we talked about
currently.
This is the sad part about this guy.
A jail sentence.
The Bishop Eddie Long joint.
What happened?
He's on CNN. Story is on CNN.
He's not on there, but the story.
The story is.
Did you see his toupee?
It's
for Sunday.
Oh, you see his shirt.
It's a Jerry.
It's getting so ridiculous. And I'm taking it past, you know, him molesting the children and whatever, oral sex.
All right,
it's ruining our community.
It is.
You are supposed to be a leader in a community, someone that parents and children and they can look up to. You know, because
when I'm going through, nothing has been proven yet. Nothing he hasn't been,
allegedly. You're right.
Alleged. This is all alleged. And let's be reminded that they weren't children. That by Georgia law, they were consenting adults, which were 16 to 17.
Hold on, but that's for a man to a woman. Right. We don't know what the Georgia law is for.
There are sodomy laws.
There you go. So he broke something.
He
broke some skin.
And I agree with Claudia about the whole outfit, the toupee and the shirt. I blame a couple of the deacons in the church. One of them should have said, "Yo, B, not that. Don't worry about that.
Let me ask you guys.
Don't worry that, B.
Let me ask you a question.
Gross.
That was a joke.
Do you think? Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, that was a joke.
Just like it's pitching.
It bottomed out.
Just a little bit outside. let me ask you this, Claudia, and I'm gonna ask you the same question to Porter. Do you think this guy first is guilty, or do you think that he should be allowed to preach?
You wanna go first, Porter?
Porter, how you feel? You think he should be allowed?
I don't know if he's guilty or not. I mean, I don't know all the facts. They haven't come in.
Well, what the facts that you have right now?
It appears that he is, but I still don't know. And we'll just have to see when that comes out. I mean, I don't want to just flat out say the
Okay, that was the answer I was looking for. Claudia, let's see how you feel about it. Hopefully you got some passion about it.
I say, if it walks like a pimp. If it talks like a pimp,
then pay it like a
it's
pimp.
It's taking pictures with young boys, it's molesting boys, and it's a pimp. He's like pimpish / molester, I think.
Yeah.
The outfits and the actions.
Should he be allowed to preach?
No. You're using God's name and using that to lure these boys in and to convince them of why you should be taking the spiritual son ceremony and take these vows against, you know, with me.
Allegedly.
Allegedly my ass, okay?
At
the end of the day, there's enough evidence. We've convicted people with less evidence, is what I'm saying.
Allegedly.
Amen to that.
Amen. Can I get it?
I have to piggyback off of Zoe's show. Zoe covered this topic last night, and he asked the question, can you trust your pastor if he's driving a Bentley?
No.
No.
What does that have to do with anything? You mean, can you trust him to drive me to church?
Can I get a loan?
Well, it means he's driving a Bentley while some are taking the bus. Some are hardly paying their rent. Some are.
But he's the pastor.
So does.
But here's what I'm saying. You know, driving a Bentley.
That is his job as pastor. That is.
First of all, that is not a job.
His job doing what? What is his job?
To pastor the church.
His job is to collect the money.
Yeah.
Lou Dick, you already spoke on it. We didn't like it.
877-2106-106 is the number to call into if you want to get in on this conversation.
You do that so well.
Speedy, weigh in on that. Do you think this guy? Do you think this guy?
I say 260.
Do you think these guys in this allegation?
sorry.
Tipping the scales.
Speedy, do you think this guy should be allowed to preach in this football or whatever?
I don't know if it's – do I think he should be allowed to? I think he should step down. I think just out of – okay, let me step down till this is cleared up and there's no more allegedly and I'm able to say this is what's going on. He should step down and say – because right now he's an eyesore.
And if he's not going to step down, he should at least raise up off the nuts.
Speaking of nuts, it's Jimmy Carter's birthday. Today?
Yeah.
He loves
Shut
peanuts.
Up.
He loves peanuts.
He's 85, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a peanut.
Jimmy Carter's old.
Yeah, he's not going to make it to the next
one. No, we don't put the numbers by the name.
So here's my thing. I think the decent thing should be for him not to preach. I'm not saying we're going to can him or whatever. I think he should not preach until these allegations are proven guilty or innocent.
He's alligators.
Allegations.
He should be speaking out.
Tony said these alligators are proven.
That's funny.
Stay focused. That's funny. Don't try to kill my comedy. I'm not Lewis.
Wow.
I got a show to do.
Okay. But that was funny.
I mean, we don't do this on Speedy County Corner, dude.
Oh, they cut that. Okay.
It's Foxhole Comedy Corner.
Yeah.
Is it really?
That's extinct, much like dinosaurs.
Yeah. Kind of like...
We got a phone call right now from Kentucky. We got Big Ben from Kentucky. Big Ben, what's happening?
That's Porter's homeboy.
What's happening, Foxhole?
What's up, Big Ben?
Hey.
Hey, man, I want to say what's up to my baby Tortoise. I ain't hollered at you in a while. What's up?
Hey, Big Ben.
Big Ben.
She drinking weed now.
Purple.
I'm
trying to get Tortoise's bud together when she comes to the Derby. Stop it, homie.
What was that?
We missed a couple of those teeth. Can you put them back in?
What'd you say?
Louis, D, brush your mustache, nigga.
No, say wash your mustache.
I said brush.
Oh,
brush.
Yeah, those consonants eat those teeth up. One thing.
W silent.
So weigh in on that. Weigh in on it there, Big Ben.
You said the hey, W is silent.
What's wrong with this nigga wearing these motherfucking Roman Greco wrestling outfits?
Roman Greco?
I never got all that out.
Oh, hilarious. Big Ben.
Roman Greco.
Outfit.
Is that it?
That's it?
That's funny. That's all he needed to say.
He blew his whole load on that? Yeah. I mean,
hey, I forgot what that
Big
thing
ben
was.
There's a lot of syllables. I thought he had a voice box.
We got a
Claudia said the W is silent.
He had a lot of extra. Well, you know, you guys.
877-2106-106.
Speaking of Eddie Long, a fourth accuser came out.
Allegedly.
And so we have.
Out of 30.
We have the clip.
Yes, very credible seeming. Very credible.
Seeming.
So we'll play it in. Oh, yeah. And you guys tell us, do you think this guy sounds real or not?
Yeah, let's play the clip.
Let's roll that.
Foxhole exclusive.
His presence alone is seduction to a young man without a father. You look at him and he's everything you want to be. He's everything you see and you dream to be. And being around him, it's almost like a drug. You can't believe the place that you're at in your life and the things that you're doing and the cars that you're driving and the people that you're meeting. So it becomes... If I want to continue to feel this love and this power, I'll do whatever my dad wants me to. I can't accept in my mind that he never was a dad to me. So I love him for that. But at the same time, for what he did to me and taught me and how I see the world, I'll never be able to forgive him for that.
Why didn't you just stop and say, Bishop, that's wrong?
You're afraid to lose your father. You're afraid that if you tell him no, the support that he gives to yourself, the support that he gives to your family, and the support that he gives to you mentally, and the fact that you finally have a father that you've always wanted for and always dreamed of, would just walk away from you if you don't give him what you want. So you end up turning into something you never thought you'd be, which is now a slave to a man that you love. If you look at us in our eyes and you hear the pain in our voice, we don't have a reason to lie to this man. I loved him and I'm always gonna have love for the things that he taught me. But how he left us hurt worse than anything I ever felt in my life. So while the media and the press and the rest of the people around the city or around the country look at us like, how can a grown man let another man touch him? What you have to understand is this man manipulated us from childhood. This was our father and we loved him. This man turned his back on us when he had no more need for us. That's not a father. That's a predator. We would have to be the craziest kids in the world to want to come out and admit to another man touching on us publicly To really believe this is about money would be absolutely ludicrous. I cannot get the sound of his voice out of my head. And I cannot forget the smell of his cologne. And I cannot forget the way that he made me cry many nights when I drove in his cars on the way home, not able to take enough showers to wipe the smell of him off of my body. But that man cannot look me in my eye and tell me we did not live this pain. While you can sit in front of the church and tell them that you categorically deny it, you can't say that to our face. And you know this. You are not a man. You are a monster.
Wow.
All right.
Wow.
I have a question.
Gives a new meaning to stunting like my daddy.
I have a question.
Father's Day.
Listen to that clip. Was he wearing a Darth Vader suit?
Why?
I thought the force was with him. Like, Jesus Christ, clean up the audio.
Your lack of hatred disturbs me.
Okay, a couple things.
No, I thought he sounded very credible.
Go ahead, Lewis.
A couple things. I thought some of it, when he was saying it was like a drug, I mean, we're talking this kid's around 16 years old.
Well, he's 23 now. That's what I'm saying. That was Jamal Paris.
Yeah, when this happened, you know, he's... And I'm assuming he's using it as a metaphor that it was a drug, like to have somebody constantly love me like this and show me some consistency. Well, but at one point,
I think
the other
part's of it too. When he
said,
with
the cars,
the cars
and
going places.
Yeah, that was the whole thing of drugging him to seduce him. But you know, the whole thing about fear when you're afraid, at one point the fear is right in your face and you have to challenge it.
No, those were his nuts.
allegedly.
And I just think
that's not the mounds.
I don't want to blame them.
Sometimes you feel like a nut.
No peanuts.
I don't want to blame them because I think 99.9% is on that monster if he did do it. But the 1%, which they could have helped themselves, which was you have to fight off that thing when it's in your face, that fear.
But Lou Dix, you're speaking as an adult. Like you said, this cat was a young man at the time.
We think he was 16.
No, a lot of creepy things happened to me when I was young.
The guy said he was doing these things.
Clearly.
No, I didn't mean it
that
way.
Come on, Lewis.
No, what I meant was...
Let the mustache go.
No, what I meant was that...
Speak on it, Lewis.
No, grown-up Philip.
Have a lifetime cry.
No. What I'm saying is that there was a lot of times where you were challenged as a young man growing up in Philadelphia... Where it could have went either way, and you had to either run.
Well, Lewis, what kind of things? I think you should.
The ice cream man.
No.
He tried to get at you.
Oh, come on, man! Everybody, ice cream man tried to get at everybody.
Not me. He never tried to get at me.
Well, he ain't get at me. I know he got out at a couple of them. He got out at Junebug. He got. But he didn't get up.
Why are you putting Junebug out like that?
Because that was his name when he was little.
Are you saying that the ice cream man stuck his dick in the snow cone and said, it gives your flavor?
Show me what you're working with.
This is vanilla.
Showed you a real Astro Pop.
Hey, we got a phone call from Atlanta. Javon. That's an R?
No, okay, R is silent.
The W is silent.
Okay, I'm sorry for mispronouncing your name. What's going on, Javon?
Hey, yo, it's Javon, yo. What's happening, y'all? What's good?
What's up,
Javon?
Hey. Yo, what's going on, yo? Check this out. All right, obviously, Atlanta's on fire because of this shit. Everybody's talking about it. This shit is crazy, right? But first of all, I think that the problem is we are exalting the people who preach the word and acting like they're infallible and above sin.
Great word.
When it's not that situation. He's a man like everybody else. You living in Atlanta where, like, there's a disproportionate number of gay dudes, download dudes. Why would you expect this pastor to be any different? He's susceptible to all this shit like everybody else is. I happen to be straight, but I'm living in a place where that shit is rampant. So I see it all the time, so I'm not tripping on it. Secondly, I always knew the dude was suspect because he got a weaved-in Jerry curl. Nobody
wow.
A Jerry curl, yo.
Oh.
Wait, why would you leave me a hair that you gotta activate?
Javon, hysterical.
Oh, that's hysterical.
You gotta activate.
That's funny,
that's
man.
What it is, yo.
That's
oh, yo,
funny.
Party of Jordan, I want to say, y'all, I appreciate you coming back, and it's a good thing hearing you on the Foxhole again. Real talk.
Thank you.
I'm out. I'll let y'all, but yeah.
All right.
Thank you, Javon.
That was a great phone call.
Javon with a W.
But I beg to differ. I think that we are supposed to look up to this guy.
Why?
Because I'm going to tell you why. When I was a kid, my pastor was someone you can look up to. You're supposed to look up to.
He was taller than
you. You're supposed to look up to someone who's the shepherd that's leading the flock. That's what happens. That's why they make him a pastor. That's why they make him over the church. You're supposed to look up to him. But when he started to do these things, as my man said,
nobody knew
what did
he was
you
ex- doing it, John.
I know, but when he started doing these things, apparently 30 people knew that he was doing these things.
Yeah.
So those 30 people, maybe they was afraid, like Lou Dick said, they was afraid to come out because they would be ostracized by the church or wouldn't nobody believe them. It's the same way like the female who screams rape and she afraid to scream rape because the law won't believe them or this dude may be a prominent citizen in our society. They might gonna believe little lonely old her, or in these cases, these young boys who was coming from another city, another state.
Right, right.
You know, they didn't have any friends. All the family friends they had was this Eddie Long. So you gotta, and the kid might have been, majority of the kids are afraid to come out. So the man, I'm supposed to look to the past because he's the shepherd leading the flock, and I respect that. But I do expect something different. When you say you're a preacher, I don't expect to see TDP say he's a preacher to see him in the club with me.
Yeah, you shouldn't be.
I don't expect to see the pastor drinking, carousing with women with me.
But I'm looking for new members.
Members only got 50. Claudia,
I think that's a good point. I want to piggyback off of what you said. You brought up the point about raping with women, and you know, a lot of times, you know, we talk about these kids being 16, 17, 18, and what you would or wouldn't do at that age. You know, when you molest or when you you try to make someone a victim like of sexuality and rape and molestation, a lot of times there's an intimidation there that people, you know, you never know what you're going to do until you're in that position.
Right.
And there's women that are grown adults. No, there's women that are, you know, grown ass.
I was going to attack when you said that position. I was going to attack.
But there's women that are like far beyond their teenage years.
He tooted and booted.
That are far beyond their teenage years that find themselves in positions of being, you know, raped. And people say, well, how can you let that happen to you? You never know until you're there. Well, you're in a position of, you know, you feel like you're.
It just coming into
overcome.
Puberty.
It's mental. It's not just physical. It's mental as well.
This kid is just coming into his puberty. His puberty just kicking in, and he's finding out who and what he is.
It's confusing.
That's
time.
Why they try to catch you. These sexual predators try to catch you when you're young. I'm not trying to compare this, but like in a dope game. Back in the dope game, I wanted to catch you when you were fresh. I don't want to wait till
you. Impressionable. When you're impressionable.
Because you're young. And like you said.
Impressionable.
Right. I want to catch you when you're young.
You're not really
That's
sure
what this
you're
cat is doing. Paul, as you can speak on it.
I was going to say, I don't know if you guys saw this, but Don Lemon on CNN, while he was reporting the story, he broke down and admitted that he was a victim of a pedophile. Mm-hmm. And he didn't, it was unscripted. That story brought that memory out of him, and he shared it on television. And he was saying that the things that the boys were describing were exactly the way that pedophiles get down.
Lou Dix,
yeah, I think there's...
Speaking of pedophile.
That's not. Daddy, get out of my room!
Yeah, that's not... I am not a pedophile. Never have been.
Anymore.
Sleep
with your son.
Well, those are jokes. But listen,
no,
on a serious tip.
You slept with your son.
I think...
serious tip.
We as...
Daddy, who's tipping?
Hey, you gonna make him come on? He get mad. Listen,
no, I'm not getting mad.
Bathwater's ready.
No. He give me that softball game look.
What I think is it's time now because you know with all this outrage and pain, it's like when are the men of the church who are there who know what's going on going to take a step forward?
Well, we don't know if they.
No, well, I mean, let's be honest. We all, as men, we know when another man is wrong. If he's close to us and we see, okay, that's just not right. It's
right,
awkward.
Right.
And we will step sideways as opposed to stepping to them. And I just think it's time that we start stepping to these weak men to protect these young boys and young girls.
He was the leader.
That's what I'm saying.
Hold on, Lewis. How can somebody up under you come tell the leader you wrong? It has to be somebody either on your level that can look you in your eyes and say, my man, you're wrong. It's like somebody younger than you trying to tell you about marriage, and they only been married a year. You would look at them and go, you can't tell me nothing. I've been in this for 16
but
years.
But even if
you tell them they're wrong, what difference is that going to make if they have an illness, if they have a sickness?
But if you're a pedophile,
you have a sickness. Yes, so just telling somebody that they're wrong, it's going to take more than
just telling them that they're wrong.
It might take something like this happening to
for them to get it.
Yeah.
But also maybe, real quick, maybe the men of the church should have taken him out on a retreat and hung out with him so that he can call them daddy for like 4 days.
Wow.
Seriously. The men of the church should take him out now somewhere and let him sit down, look them in the eye, the men, and say, what's going on?
I think I saw that movie.
Calm down, Junebug.
You sure got a pretty mouth.
Yeah, I don't know.
I think so.
Well, even the neighbor that just came out said they saw... Sorry.
go ahead.
The neighbor that saw that is now coming out saying, oh, by the way, I did see Bishop Eddie Long with the young kid every single day. Like, he should have stepped up forward.
But he didn't think nothing was wrong with it because he's working over the youth pastor.
I'm going to say what Lewis Dick says. Some parts was said was true. You know, looking at it with the naked eye, you know what something just ain't right. It reminds me of a story like Chris Spencer. So I was at the mall one time, and I seen this lady with Chris Spencer's son. And I didn't know who the lady was. So I saw the lady, you know, I spoke to her, hey, little Chris. I played with him. And so some strange lady just came and got the little buggy and pushed him on out. I ran behind that lady, called Chris Spencer on the phone, and chased that lady because it just didn't
who
look
was it?
Right.
Who was it?
It was the
nanny.
It was the wife's mother.
But how stupid did you look?
No, how great did I look? I at least
thank
did something.
You. Thank you, yes.
I did something because it just didn't look right. A quick phone call fixed the whole situation. What if I would have did nothing and now this child is kidnapped?
Better safe than sorry.
Yes, thank you. I agree.
And
Johnny,
I agree with Lil Dick said. Now, we got a phone call,
Miles
stupid
Johnny
Speedy.
That's
we got right. a phone call from Houston, Kevin. I like the way you write. We have Kevin from Houston.
He spelled it phonetically.
H-O-O.
What's up, Kevin?
What's going on, Fox?
What's going on, bro?
Hey, hey.
Been a long time listening to you guys. It's the first time
appreciate
I ever called.
Welcome.
Listen,
thank
I want to comment on this whole mega church thing and what it's doing in our community and what it should be doing in our community.
Right.
First of all, this mega church thing, it's all about money, man. Let's be real on this. These guys are making a tremendous amount of money. Most
tax-free.
Of the time off
tax-free.
The backs of people that don't really have a whole lot of money. You know? And these people are faithful. They're in church. This guy has a church that's worth $50 million. He's driving a Bentley. You know, I heard Zoe Williams last night, and he said something very interesting. And this is something that a lot of these mega church pastors are not doing. Martin Luther King gave away every dime of his Nobel Peace Prize to the cause that he was fighting for.
And Malcolm X.
I don't see any of these mega church pastors giving away anything. If anything, they're taking everything. And what you have to understand about this whole situation, I don't know if this guy is innocent or guilty or whatever, but I tell you what, it doesn't look good. And now, when you catch young kids that don't have father figures in their life, they don't have a whole lot of money, their mother doesn't have a whole lot of money.
Right.
My wife and I had this conversation. And let me tell you something. I'll be damned if I'm going to let my son or any child of mine go off with some guy. I don't care if he's a pastor or who he is and not know where he is, not know what they're doing. My wife, if my son has to go somewhere with the school or something, you can best believe one of us is chaperoning with him to see what's going on. And I think oftentimes what's happening in the world today, we are too easy to just let our kids go away with anybody and have a good time. And there's no oversight into what they're doing when they get there. Right. So I think this is all about money. You know, these guys are all about to get whatever they can. What the hell does this guy need a Bentley for? Should he be putting some of this money back in the community to the people that can't pay their rent, that can't
That's
make
true.
It from day to day? I mean, this is outrageous to me. And for anybody, you know, I just think you guys touched on something a minute ago to say, why didn't the people in the church, you know, senior people in the church pull him aside? Because they don't want to cut their money off. What are they going to say? These guys
point.
Are going to go along to get along because it's all about money.
You're right.
Tell me what's wrong.
Thank you Kevin, that was a great phone call.
Great
I love
call,
your statement.
Bud Light phone call of the week.
And that was great. You hit the nail right on the head. We're going to take a quick break.
Where are we going?
And we're going to come back and give us a phone call. What's the number, Speedy?
877-2-106-106.
8772. I'm going to say it in a man's voice.
Yeah. Thank
8772-106-106.
Speaking of man's voice, it's Randy Quaid's birthday.
Hey, call in and let us know how you wear it,
Randy.
You know?
Call it.
The Fox Soul, Series 106, XM 149. We'll be right back. Yeah.
It's an easy song to sing. Y'all ready?
Girls stand up.
It's
real easy. What's real easy? Watch it. Here go like that.
He wrote this in crayon.
This right here is my
swag.
All the girls are on me. Damn.
My daughter loves
it.
This come with a special helmet. This come with a helmet, I tell you that.
With your picture on.
Pretty boy. Pretty boy. Swag. Bishop Eddie
Fag.
Bishop Eddie Fag. Bishop Eddie Fag.
We're going to hell.
Bishop Eddie
Fag. Pick it up. Play one piece.
Jay's onesie on.
Got on the leotard backwards.
I ain't asking for no hot dog.
We got to go to my man Lou Dix.
Hey, hello, Fox, all the great Foxhole listeners out there. I'm Louis Dix, and I would like to let you all know that the Foxhole crew is rolling out on tour. We're going out on tour. BMW North America is part of the Foxhole family, and because of that, we get to drive the BMW 5 Series Gran Turismo. That's right.
We're not flying?
No. We are flying there, but once we get there, the cars will be there to pick us up. Now, the cool thing is, our listeners can still keep in touch with us because the BMW GT is loaded with crazy technology. Check this out. It's like a communication central, all right? This innovative thing they got called Connected Drive that lets you check out traffic and emails and Blackberries.
In your car?
In your car. And, Speedy, plenty of room for any girl you pick up. So, you know, that's how it rolls. So, thanks, BMW North America, and we look forward to meeting all of you out there in America. We're going to have a great tour, BMW 5 Series. We're out.
If you're doing all that in the car, ain't you going to have an accident? You
checking
your internet and your Facebook and your... That's a whole...
Well, that's for the person and that's for the girl.
Oh.
Does your car have a sunroof? Because you sure do.
I just got a haircut, Speedy.
No, not at the top you did.
No, you got an haircut in 84.
Hey, when God cuts your hair, he don't cut it either.
He a hell of a barber, though.
So, the other day on Twitter, there was a big a trending topic, which means something that's really popular, what everybody's talking about. So there was one that was a lot of fun. It was called Bishop Eddie Long's Ringtones.
Wow.
So what songs do you think Eddie Long's ringtones would be? So I don't know if you guys care to like go. Oh, Donnie, man.
Me and Little Boy Jones.
Billy got back.
Shake it up, because Billy got back.
One of my favorites, Trey Songz, Bottoms Up. Bottoms Up.
How about Ring Around the Rosie?
Okay.
Swing and a miss there by Socia.
Your comedy is the joke.
Someone said, I go hard in the tank.
DDP, I know you got to like this one. He liked the boys in the band.
He said that I was not my favorite.
And you got...
When I get there, they got instant wine and candles.
It's such a freaking thing.
And you guys like Katy Perry, right? Katy Perry?
Yeah.
He kissed a boy.
And he liked it. Dude looked like a lady.
Hysterical.
You said, Speedy, you said one of your favorites was what? Young love.
Gotta have a young neck.
A rough neck.
No, a young neck.
You know what he told the little boys at late at night?
Beat it.
Wake me up before you go.
Going so low.
And the number one ringtone
is
how much is that little boy in the window? The one with the little ponytail.
Oh, no. It's awful, you guys.
How much is that little boy in the window?
How much is the boy?
That's not funny, man.
Oh. Hey, we got another fuck.
Portis.
Here's my thing. Don't commit these type of crimes. We don't tell no jokes.
Don't tell no jokes. Portis first before you get to your call.
No.
What?
Oh, you know.
On my song?
No. Well, if you had a song.
You have a song?
Where the Boys Are.
Yep. Wow.
All right. Speed, that's why they put me in charge right now.
Yeah. My bad. I had a Louis Dix moment right there. My bad.
It's catchy.
But your hair was coming out.
Yeah, it fell out.
We got a phone call from Oklahoma.
For real?
BK.
All right.
Shouts out to the Sooners.
Oklahoma State.
Boys and kids. What's up, dog?
What's up, Foxhole?
What's going on with it, brother?
Yeah, I just wanted to chime in on the Eddie Long thing, man.
Sure.
I really don't think he should step down right now until all the evidence come out or whatever. I don't really see why y'all saying he should step down. He haven't been, then he wouldn't be set up the same principle that he telling to his audience.
What?
But don't you think if he stepped down that some of this would die down? The fact that he's still preaching and still going about business as if though it doesn't exist keeps the story going?
Not really, because he tells his listeners and Christian beliefs and values that when you're accused, when you're blamed for stuff, to stay strong and don't worry about it.
What do you think about the pictures? Do you think they were appropriate pictures to send to those boys? Because that's the one thing that we do have evidence of those pictures that were really sent.
Yeah, why would you send those pictures to little boys?
Well, 16.
Yeah, I don't agree with the pictures part, but just the statement that they got just made, y'all played a few minutes ago, just didn't seem right to me, the way he was talking.
Well, you got to understand, it's not a professional tape or whatever. This cat probably just did this in the comfort of his own home. But I'm saying, where there's smoke, there's fire. As a pastor, as a leader, a congressman, or whatever, you shouldn't put yourself in a situation.
It's supposed to be better than that.
You should not be, these type of allegations should not even be put up on you, because I should not be alone with several boys. I should not be on a retreat with boys.
Calling me daddy.
I should not be, no boy that's not my biological son, or say I married someone and make it my steps or whatever, no teenage boy should be calling me daddy. Yeah. That's inappropriate right there.
And
yeah, I agree with that. But what if somebody blamed Obama for the same type of shit?
Hold on, we're not talking about. Let's deal with the facts in hand, BK. Yeah, let's not speculate what could have been, because I could have been born a millionaire, but I'm not. So let's just talk about the
facts.
You got $100. At hand. It's actually $123. At the facts at hand, why would you put yourself in a position where you're taking little boys on retreats, not boys and girls that's been chaperoned by parents, you on a retreat with these little boys?
What pastor is text messaging boys his picture? Why are you doing that?
That's not what Christ is here for. That's not what you're supposed to be preaching to your congregation. You're supposed to be preaching how to get to heaven, how to live a nice, good, clean, spiritual, and moral life to get to heaven. What is you alone with little boys got to do with my salvation? Speak on that, BK.
But you know what? Not so much the little
BK hung up.
I'm sorry. Is BK still with us?
BK.
Yeah, I don't agree with that shit either.
BK.
BK for barely knowing shit. Go ahead, BK.
No, I don't agree with it either, but you can still take young men on retreats and show them how to be men, and show them how to be respectful, and show them how to treat women. But with the rest of that shit, you just can't blame it on them taking them on retreats.
No, but it would be other parents. It would be other people there.
Fathers.
As well. Remember, if I'm not mistaken, he went with just the kids by himself.
He brought in a little boy from North Carolina and said, you know, I'm going to get you an apartment, whatever, whatever. Don't you get a girlfriend. Stay single. What is that?
That's Sugar
inappropriate
Daddy
behavior.
Lewis Dix has a question.
Yeah,
thank you for the phone call, man.
Thanks, man, for
but
the phone
call. What about the brothers that really want to be out there helping young men? Because a lot of the young men... They grow up in homes without fathers. What about the brothers that are honestly out there, not touching kids, but really want to be responsible?
You have to, it's like, I work with kids a lot, and you have to be overly cautious, even when you work with young girls, too, because I coach girls in basketball.
Impossible.
And kids are innocent. Kids want to come up and hug you, but you have to turn to your side and hug them on the side.
That's right.
You high-five them.
Yeah.
You make sure any interaction is there, another adult is there.
That's true.
You just have to cover yourself.
That's true.
Otherwise, somebody's going to look at you crooked because they're crooked.
That's true.
And you just have to and for him to be a pastor.
Great point.
You know, he should be well aware of that.
What you say is 100% true. My brother's a teacher, and a lot of the kids get close to him. You know, like, they feel like he's a father figure to them, and they want to go home with him, and, you know, like, they want to, after business hours, they want to hang with him. They look at him like a real father, and he's like, as much as I want to help these kids, Claudia, I can't, because it's too easy to get accused of things.
I'm going to ask Lewis, I'm sorry, go ahead, Speedy.
I'll go after you, Luke.
I'm going to say something else that was totally different, because I'm tired of hearing the father figures,
I
look at him as a dad. I'm tired of hearing this shit.
I think anytime someone else's kid calls you father, right then you have to stop. I'm not your dad.
I'm about to get to you.
I had friends, and my boy would date somebody, and then they have a kid, and he go, next thing I know, I hear the kid call him dad. I'm like, dude, what the hell going on? Well, I said it was cool. No, it's not cool.
No, it's not.
The kid has a father. Now, they may look at you, and they may want to say, well, he's like a father to me, but I don't want him to call. They should be calling him dad.
I think that's, and I that's agree with you totally, Speedy. Right, now, here's my thing, and Lou, you can weigh in on this. What is this father figure thing? What do we mean by I looked at him like he was my father? I looked at him as a dad. My father is living.
Yeah, your daddy lived.
My father's living.
I met your daddy.
You know, and I can tell you a whole bunch of stories about my father.
Shake it like a salt shaker.
But I don't. Maybe you can weigh in. What is this? I needed a father figure. I looked at him as a father.
Well, a lot of guys get that from coaches. What happens is a lot of men.
I looked at my coach as a coach.
Well, in a point of he taught you fatherly things, right, wrong, male. It's really not so much father. It's male. It's rites of passage with
it's
the male.
Guidance.
Guidance. There you go. That's the word. It's you say that as a father figure, like Nick, Speedy's son. when we coached during the season, every now and then he'd slip and say, "Dad," and I'm like, "No, no, Speedy's your dad, Nick. Speedy's your dad."
A bitch.
I think that comes from a lot of people lacking.
Nick was trying to upgrade.
If you take me home,
well, that's, I think that comes from still be in a lot of our kids lacking their real fathers in their lives, and they want that. Some the kids that need that.
Yeah,
my father wasn't really around, so I looked at my coach like fatherly.
I didn't. I looked at.
I met your dad.
But you have a dynamic father.
My father was cool. My father left when I was 9. Can I tell you a funny story? Yeah. Speedy was there. I've never spent the night at my father's house.
You still?
I see why.
And I brought this up. We went to play dominoes at my dad's house, and I told this to my to Speedy in front of my father, and that's what he said. What he said, TDP? He said, "You still ain't."
That's incredible.
I look at when I played high school and junior high school sports. That was a coach.
But that was just you, John.
We got to stop. Charles Barkley said it best. I am not your role model. Charles Barkley tried to make Michael Jordan your role model.
Yes,
he said, "I am not your role model. I am a basketball player. I don't need to look over across the street for somebody to be a father figure to me. I'm smart enough, even when I was a teenager, when I was an adolescent, to learn right and wrong. I knew that guy was not my dad. I didn't need no father influence. I could come home to my mother and these 9 brothers and sisters I got and get everything that I needed."
So speaking of dads, Tom Bosley's birthday is today.
So you're none of yourself?
What's called?
Go ahead, Claudia.
We have a caller on the line. Someone that says she has some inside. A very strong opinion. I can't talk today. A very strong opinion on this. Her name is Popra.
Popra,
welcome to the show.
Oprah with the P.
Oprah with a P in front.
Oh, okay. Popra. I just saw her a couple days ago.
Okay, what's up, Popra? Change that.
Hey, what's up, guys? How you doing?
Hey,
girl.
Well, I mean, of course, I didn't even know anything about this until Claudia tweeted it, and it's weird because I had just tweeted myself about my book coming out, and I didn't, you know, make this call about the book, but it was really about the fact that I relate to people who are experiencing this pressure from these high-figure people. And I'm glad that if this is true, that these guys are coming out, because that's the same way I feel in my book about celebrity encounters. People who are in powerful positions, who use their power, whether it's financial, professional, political, to make other people submit to their sexual needs and their sexual interests, are monsters, and it's disgusting. And it's not going to change until somebody addresses it. And like, I'm working with a lot of young females right now who are experiencing the same thing that I experienced 15, 20 years ago. And I'm like, I can't believe it has still not changed. Now the gay men running the industry, now the young guys are experiencing it. So I pray to God it's not true, but if it is, he needs to be exposed.
Didn't you say you knew someone that had experience with him?
Well, I won't say somebody who, you know, had a physical or sexual encounter with him.
Hold on for a second, Popra, you know what?
We're
going to call you right back.
Called her Okra.
We're going to call you right back.
Hold up, Okra.
You should need to get on your book. Go on and call KGLH.
No, she told me that she had someone that.
No, but really, I did a movie project.
Hold on for 1 second. We're going to call you right back. We're going to call you right back.
Somebody push that mute button.
Press that number down.
Okay, thank you. She calling about her goddamn book.
Well, she really didn't.
But. Oh, my God.
Yeah,
I think she was getting to it.
No. She
no. Speaking of getting to it, Al Sharpton's birthday.
We got another phone call, a real phone call from Oakland. We got my man James. What's up, James?
Shouts out to the Eastmont Mall.
What up, James?
What's up, y'all forgot one. The number one ringtone got to be a Keith Sweat. You may be young, but you're ready.
Hysterical. You wrong, man. You wrong.
Oh, that was funny. That is funny.
Colin.
That's funny.
You may be young, but you're ready.
That's what we want. Thanks for the phone call, Tim.
On a serious term, let's talk about this. We as black people, because I'm a black man, we are somewhat responsible, because the first thing we do is coddle these cats and protect them. If this were a white man who had been doing this to some young brothers, we'd have shut it down a long time ago. He needs to be taken out from speaking, have an investigation, and if he's exonerated, then we say that. But if not, we cannot allow him to keep doing what he's doing, because who knows what he's going to do in the meantime. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And let's think about preachers for a second. Preachers have always been something else before they were preachers. They were criminals. They was a drug addicted. They was drug dealers. They was always something else before they became preachers. So when we put all these people in these different high religious positions, we got to know, first of all, they're men, and they're flawed men. And so, you know, we can't be surprised when they get out and do this kind of thing. And another thing, why in Georgia can
difference between a Georgia kid and a California kid?
Well, Georgia kid go out in the fields and work back in the day and all that. So,
you know. Was that a joke?
No, it was kind of true, but you look at
what the hell.
Well, I mean, there's laws in the southern laws, and then there's northern laws, and then the consent people got married when they were 12 and 13, so the consent of sexual was down at 16. Where the northern states, people, it's more modern. Your kids should be able to grow, go to school.
It needs to be one age across the country, I think.
Well, you shouldn't be able to get married until you're 38, so you know what life's about.
Well, I agree. If you have parents' consent, you know, back in those days, that's what they did, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, this is a new day and time, and an adult home alone or on a retreat alone.
That's a movie.
With a boy in a hotel or in an apartment by himself is inappropriate. Whether you do something to that kid or not, that is inappropriate behavior.
It's not going to look right.
Why are you putting young boys? I'm taking in a hotel with a dude, a little boy.
Or you're paying some dude's rent. What are you doing?
Yeah, what are you paying somebody rent for?
I'm telling you.
Shit, you could have paid mine.
Making him.
I never would have told on you, Eddie Long.
But you know what? I got to give Eddie Long props, though. For him to be able to send texts. Messages with the Jerry curl is pretty incredible.
You saying his hands are slippery?
Yes, slippery. Oh,
okay. That joke? Let me ask you something about your comedy.
Ruin outside there.
What happened, Lou?
That was funny. It was kind of little intelligent, little thought provoking.
But you would have had to wait for the audience to go, oh, dude, it's funny.
This dude got appetizer comedy.
Don't eat that one. Don't eat that yet.
Finger food or funny.
Lewis, keep on trying, though. Finger eventually, you'll get there.
Chow Mein comedy presents.
You'll get there.
We got another phone call from Maryland.
Keep trying, Lou Dix.
Finger food.
Keep trying, Lou Dix. You know.
He's a.
You know what you should do? This you should do. Before the joke. Turn around to these people in the back behind
you. Try it on them.
Try it on them.
If they don't laugh.
Now, if they hit you in the face with a tomato, don't tell that joke.
But I say you keep on going 16, 17, 18 times, no matter how many times it takes. You'll be like the Susan Lucci of comedy.
Speaking of hurting, Sting's birthday.
Yeah, we got another phone call from Maryland. We got Lawn from Maryland. What's up, Lawn?
Lawn's here. Turn your radio down.
Hello?
Hello?
Turn your radio down.
It's Ron. It's actually Ron.
Ron.
Oh, Ron.
Yeah, the L is silent.
I wanted to say hello to all of y'all, but I just wanted to speak on the situation. I just want to make sure that we don't get some of the things out of context as it pertains to the mega churches. We have to realize that this is a man, and there are some of these men who are out here, predators and monsters, but these churches do a lot of good in the community. I think there's a lot of blacks and others that can speak to the saying that the churches do way more harm than good. And it's unfortunate that you have somebody with the size of the church of this magnitude doing what he did, because flat out, honestly, I believe he did it.
Let me ask you a question, Ron. What good do they do? These mega churches, what good do they do?
Yeah, name three things.
For instance, I'm part of a mega church, and I work in the church, and we feed the homeless. We go.
Your
out.
Cell phone ain't even good.
You need a new plan.
Yeah. You need to join a new church.
Yeah, you got every other word plan.
Half off.
You got a baby Baptist phone.
Yeah, you're supposed to get in the baptismal with your phone.
Go ahead, Ron. Go ahead.
Well, name the good things, because me and Claudia, I personally don't believe in the mega churches. I do not believe
it's
in them.
Pimping.
I'm not going to call it pimping. I'm going to call it extortion. But I don't believe that it does
well,
any good
go
in
Ron.
The community. So, Ron, name three things that these mega churches does.
Or the one he goes to.
Or do.
Well, like I said.
Yeah, he ain't no English major.
I participate in the church, and we go out and we feed homeless people.
You do what?
We go out and feed homeless people. I go every other Saturday.
There you go.
The church that I attend, and we go to three different locations down in Washington, D.C.
Okay, that's one thing.
Every other Saturday?
Well, Ron, the reason why they're homeless is because they're giving all the money to you guys at the mega church.
Right.
So you can buy his crappy phone.
Two more, Ron.
You ain't even getting them no lawn chairs to sleep on.
Well, he's lying.
Okay, what else you guys do?
Name another one.
Sick and shut in. I mean, I've gone out and my friends have gone out. We've gone to the hospital and visited people that are sick or shut in their homes. And I've actually known a couple of people who have received funds to get their rent paid.
Ron, at your sick sit-in, what you just called it. Did you heal anybody? So what good did you do?
So a gang of
you just made the hospital crowded.
So a gang of healthy, well-fed, non-sick people go say what's up to some sick
yeah,
people.
Yeah, I'm dying of
so the same people that you feed, you make them sick, and you go see them at the hospital.
And then you say, it's going to be
all right. Macaroni.
And you say, that's going to be all right. You're going to make it. Just pray to Jesus.
Man. Okay, so name another thing that the mega
okay, that's two things. One more thing.
Well, I can speak from this also, too. I mean, my family lost everything with Katrina. And the church stepped in big time financially and
what
it
most
important helping.
What did they give you?
Katrina robbed y'all?
Money.
They gave him some rubber boats.
Well, I'm glad you know how to swim.
Did they give you one of those trailers with the cyanide in it? No, there's trailers with the drug. There's a.
Did they give you a Best Buy box to float on?
No, be a river.
No, Ron. Ron,
this is Eddie Carroll, Eddie Long, and Carol Kid.
What's up, bro? Hey, Ron.
Do you do hair?
I wanted to ask you a question, Ron. Louis Fix. No, seriously. What? How much money did you get?
For what?
When he said that
they told
how much money did you get in dollars?
From Katrina? 8,
from the church. How much?
$8,000.
How many chains did you buy?
That's a lot of money. That's a lot of money.
That's enough to get you started in another
city. I can make it happen.
I can take that and flip that.
Flip that.
Yeah.
Make them trips to Chicago.
Plus the 7 I give you.
Plus the 1 I gave you.
And the 1
they
gave me.
Motherfucker, can you buy that?
hey, Ron, thank you so much for the call, man. I wish you the best.
Good luck with that.
Yeah, good luck with the. I'm sorry that Katrina robbed you and your family for all the things you have. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, the $8,000 gets you back on your feet.
That's right.
And I hope that your mega church proves me wrong.
They will.
And does great things in the community. Because the community I live in, the mega church don't do shit.
Right.
Now, we're going to take a quick break.
Put some more cheese on the macaroni.
We're feeding the homeless every other week. Okay.
That ain't shit.
That's good.
What they do for the other 13 days?
Hey, you go hungry.
Hey, they got to wait.
Yeah. How long could a bologna sandwich
last? Yeah, this dude's driving a Bentley. That's what I'm saying.
That's what I'm saying. And they got private.
What year jet. Bentley? They got certain years. What year Bentley?
Probably 2009.
That's nice.
He got a Beamer Benz and Bentley.
Beamer Benz.
And boys.
Beamer Benz and boys.
Maybe. Yo, we can take a quick break and come right back to the Foxo Series 106 XM 149.
Get it long, ringtones. Oh. Call in.
We back.
Yeah, we're wow, back. And you know what?
Welcome to Atlanta.
Luda.
Welcome to Atlanta.
Where the little boys play.
They smoke.
My name is
Robe every day.
I know Eddie Long Robe is stained like a motherfucker on the inside.
Stained on the inside, clean on the outside.
I need some holy water to wash this stain off.
John, you're going to hell.
Yeah, got some good barbecue down there, though. Rip tip, pick it up. You just can't get it to go. It's all you can eat.
Do those tips come with Bud Light?
If we're going to go to pour this without Bud Light, read.
You want your tips with Bud Light.
What?
Quiet on the yard.
Beauty is
Bud
real.
Bud Light with superior drinkability, that just right taste. Not too heavy, not too light, and unique ability to elevate good times.
It goes great with fish.
I was going to say something sad. That's going to be true.
Don't say nothing sad.
Not on this one. Come on.
What are we going to say? I want to know now.
You got a ringtone for me?
We got to keep it fun, social.
It was very tasteless.
Oh. Somebody said you have father figures in jail.
Wow. Cell number 10.
But I didn't drop the soap. Go ahead,
Bud Light is fun, social, and the perfect beer for bringing people together. Bud Light's drinkability.
Yeah, baby.
Where's your Bud Light today?
Johnny Mac.
They didn't give me one.
Bud Light to everybody.
I need a Bud Light.
The educated one.
That just right taste. Not too heavy, not too light is what sets Bud Light apart from other light beers. It's the sure sign of a good time. That just right taste.
It goes great with calamari.
With what?
Random.
What? Calamari.
Oh, I thought you were talking about that coach at
That's Calipari.
Oh, okay.
That just right taste of good.
What's that coach got to do with anything?
How'd you get a food item wrong though?
I love you anyway.
That just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go, y'all.
Here we go.
With your divorced ass.
Not quite yet.
Hey, stay focused.
Oh, you said she was on an ex-wife beater.
We gotta go down to she's wearing an ex-wife beater.
I'm still a married woman.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Allegedly. Allegedly.
Not to him, you ain't.
I bet your cat did, though.
Shut up.
We got to go to my man, Lou Dix.
Hey, you know, it's always because I am me. And hello to all the great Foxhole listeners out there. I am Louis Dix, and that's D-I-X. Man, come on.
CK.
Your thigh should not be shown.
I would like.
This nigga, you got taco meat on his thigh.
No, I don't. Man.
Yeah,
I
why
would
you
like
them little shorts?
His first
why
name is
Sucker. Why his thighs?
What are you looking at? Because he's trying to get an Eddie Long moment.
Speedy, I think you're homophobic.
He's swung around in his BMW.
Hold on 1 second. Hold on 1 second. Go ahead, Lou Dix.
Thank you very much, Johnny Mac. Hey, the Foxhole crew is rolling out on tour. That's right, guys. We're out. Who's going? You going, Speedy?
Not with them thighs.
Hey, you know what? You know what? I'm going to make you sit in front because I'm going to drive. Oh. Listen, BMW of North America is part of the Foxhole family. And because of that, we get to drive the BMW 5 Series Gran Turismo. That's right. Now, the cool thing is our listeners can still keep in touch with us. You can email. Go ahead.
I was going to say you're going to tour Inglewood, El Segundo.
we're on a 26-city bathroom tour. All your club bathrooms gonna be up.
Papa,
I'm telling you, this the BMW GT is loaded with crazy technology, and I know you like technology, Speedy.
Yes, I do.
It's like communication central, so the girls can, your kids can email you BlackBerry, and I'm sure we can get at least four of your kids in the
Speedy
trunk.
Yeah, because Speedy don't know how to work it.
Yeah, because he's always emailing you.
You
too,
see
Johnny.
Four kids in the trunk?
Yeah, I didn't mean that bad. That didn't come out right.
You mean
Mamma
mia. Serial killer wear anything.
Hey, listen, BMW North America, thank you so much for partnering up with us. We're looking forward to the tour. Come on out. Meet us, say hi,
get
and I'll
car.
Show you my BMW. That's cool. Yeah, girls can come
please
get in my BMW.
Please wear pants.
How many people can fit in a BMW?
Actually, comfortably, six.
How many in the trunk?
We didn't get no play from the ladies, but six people in the car. Are you crazy? We have to get that in there.
I see.
We have to get that in.
Louis still don't know what you're
doing. We have a special.
Yeah, Louis, you got to start wearing pants to the show.
Yeah.
I didn't know dude had thighs. So you
booty shorts.
Speaking of pants,
like
it's Donna Karen's birthday.
Love Donna Karen.
On the phone with us.
Is that a drink?
Speaking of birthdays. Yeah, speaking of birthdays, we have a special guest on the phone with us. He's Def Jam recording artist. He debuted with the hit single Birthday Sex.
Oh, that's my man.
Chicago's own Jeremiah, who will be performing live at the Foxhole. What's
hey,
going
Jeremiah.
On?
What's up, man?
I'm chilling, man. I'm chilling at the crib right now in my hometown, Chicago, man. Feels good to
Chi-town.
Be
here. Chi-town. Chi-town.
We're coming to Chicago.
Welcome right. to the show.
Hey, you got hook up on the Goose Island?
On the who now?
You got hook up on the Goose Island shrimp and fries. You got hook up on that?
Oh, man, you know I got everybody around the city, man. He should have just hooked me up by now.
Let me ask you a question about this song. This was a great song.
Great song.
Love this song.
I played this song for a whole year and lied to every girl that it was my birthday. So I want to thank you for all the premarital sex you allowed me to have off this song.
Thank you.
What inspired this song, my man?
Man, you know, I just was writing. You know, I'm a writer. I wrote my entire album. It was actually my breakout song. And when I write, I kind of just like to speak metaphorically. And it's crazy how I was able to even write a song and make it playable on the radio with the title of A Birthday Sex. You know, but I think it was the renaissance of every song afterwards, making it cool to say the word sex. You know what I'm saying, on the song. So, I don't know. I just was writing, man, and speaking things into existence. And sure enough, it happened.
Ain't nothing like beautiful. Birthday sex,
hey,
either. Birthday sex is good,
hey,
right?
Mr. Felton, this is Louis Dix. And all the...
Why you put his government name out there?
No,
yeah,
all,
man.
Hey, listen.
Let's call him Jeremiah.
Okay, Jeremiah. Excuse me. I really enjoy
the song. W is silent.
But with all the
stupid
Mr. Felton, with all the songs, birthday songs. Did you take that in consideration when you titled the song? Because the birthday sex, the birthday, it's hot in here. A lot of birthday songs. I see that, Mac. That's why I said Mr. Felton.
Don't say that.
You know, actually, well, I know it's other ones. All I could probably think of off top is probably Stevie Wonder's. You
yeah,
know,
really.
With the last real big birthday type of anthem in which they'll sing other than the traditional happy birthday song. But
right.
I don't know, man. I really just was writing it. To me, it was just another song. And when I started hearing it on the radio and people reaction to it from the ages, crazily, from like 9, 10 to late 50s, you know, I was saying people really, really love the record. And I feel like it's just one of those songs that just... I had no clue how big it was going to be, but just for it to see it hit number one, man, that was just crazy for me.
Wow.
Yo, this is your boy Speedy, man. And when does the album actually drop, or has it dropped already?
Well, the new album just dropped this past Tuesday. You know,
Tuesday.
I think since then, it's been getting more buzz than ever since it came out. It dropped on Tuesday. And I think people were just really, you know, still on the last album. I kind of took some time off this year to make sure I gave you all the best and none less. You know, I went out for 2 months to St. Louis and recorded what I think is probably my best piece of work thus far. And just looking forward to this year and letting everybody hear.
Cool. Okay, this is your second album. I'm sorry. This is your second
All
album.
About You.
All About You. I just got signed last year. I got signed to Def Jam, what's that, March of 2009. And so
how does it feel
to
be signed
Watch your tone.
such an iconic label, and then this is your second album. So what are some of the things that you learned that you brought into the second album that you did in the first album?
Well, the first album, you know, I was just writing records, and I just ended up keeping most of them, you know, for myself. I was hoping to get placements for other artists, but, you know, I'm glad how everything worked out. And I think my first album had hints of what I felt I can do musically, because before, I'm an audio doesn't play of me. And I think on this album, people will get at least a bit more gist of who Jeremiah is. So
that's right.
I'm looking forward to this one, man. It's called All About You. I dedicated it to all my fans.
So when you, this is Johnny Mac, when you enrolled in college at the age of 16, University of Illinois, did you get your degree in engineering that you was pursuing at first, or you just cut that
short in? I went there for engineering science, you know, via my mom's or whatnot, thinking, you know, that just being told that was just a broad, you know, field of study to get into. So I did it, you know, and over like my second year out there, I just started getting involved a lot in all the little homecoming shows, you know, the cotton clubs and whatnot, and I started performing, and I think music began to take over. And that's when I, you know, I had to holler at my moms and tell her, like, yo, I think I should go to an art school. You know, maybe not learning actually how to sing or how to play, because at the time I wasn't singing. I really started singing a little over 2 years ago. And that was based off me learning off playing a piano. You know,
wow.
I think playing a piano really taught me how to just sing or hold a note and sound it out, and just built my ear for it. So over time, I ended up transferring to Columbia College, which is an art school downtown Chicago. And from there on, I think it was pretty much history. That was just two and a half years ago when I did that.
Wow.
And while going there, I met the right people. Shout out to Mick Schultz. He produced the first entire album and even his second album, and I met him there. And since then, like I said, Birthday Sex was coming out while I was even sitting in class. You know what I'm saying? And eventually I had to stop because people still didn't know who it was. Everybody thought it was either R. Kelly or, you know, The Dream or all these different comparisons.
I sure did.
In which I thought, you know, I'm like, yo, for a second, it was hard for me even to back up that they had nothing to do with it, you know. But I think that just proved a lot, because those are two great artists, you know, and just to be even compared to them as a relatively new artist, it just means a lot. So,
I thought it was Eddie Long.
Jeremiah.
You thought it was Eddie Long?
Jeremiah.
Birthday sex.
Hilarious. Oh, man. No, not
Jeremiah.
That good.
Claudia has a question.
This is Claudia. I met you in Miami at the Haiti the fundraiser they had for Haiti. BET had a big fundraiser, and we all had to answer phones at the telethon. This isn't a question, just a comment. I just wanted to say, like, reading your bio and finding out that you graduated high school at 16 and, you know, your background, I really want to commend you on the way you carry yourself. Like, your song is a sexual song, but the way you carry yourself, you're a classy performer, and you remind me of the old school R&B singers, you know, the real R&B music that we always say we miss. And I just want to give you your props and tell you, you know, keep up the good work.
Thank you.
I have a question
for
you,
number
Jeremiah. I have a question. When you was in college and they started playing your song, and then people realized that it was you, did your groupie status go sky high?
Man.
What was your one night stand ratio at the time?
Man, you know, I always been pretty good with the ladies, you know, but I could definitely say once that record hit, and I think not even just that song, but even other records off my album in which I think it's kind of cool because I know the ladies love it, but just to even have the guys be able to ride to it and get ladies off of it too is a lot. You know, it means a lot as to other R&B artists, which not many guys probably, you know, mess with like that as far as musically. So I just was like, you know, over the time, I ain't gonna lie, man, every day, every show, it was almost.
Especially
you know,
the one.
Right, it goes great with fish.
The one line you said, got me on 10, POTUS. I know you know that line.
We got a quick. Lou Dix got a question.
Yeah.
What's up, man?
Hey, I wanted to ask you, at what point did you make a decision in your life that you felt was a good decision that helped you?
Yeah.
Bishop
Dix.
No.
What I wanted to ask you was, here's the thing. The decision.
His first name is Suckler.
No, the decision.
Suckler the Dix.
I was going to ask you if you could tell us the decision that you felt helped.
What's his first name, John?
Suckler the Dix.
What I'm asking you is.
No, you ain't asking him shit.
I'm asking for people out there is make?
What's his first name, John?
Suck a lot of dicks.
Jeremiah, put your jacket on. He's going in.
No, Jeremiah, listen.
Go ahead,
Lucas. What decision do you feel you made along your career that helped change you to get where you needed to go? That was an important decision. Like, during the course of you might have come to a fork in the road and you said, I'm going to do this instead of that.
A fork in the road.
Well, you know what? Like I said, man, before all this, I attended Columbia even before then, even when I was at U of I, I started getting into production. That's all I was doing. I swore up and down, and that was my way to get in the game. Like, I had so many beats, and even everybody around me, I started meeting all type of artists and rappers and singers, and I was just like, yo, I got too many beats. I'm tired of just hearing these beats. I want to see if someone can bring them to life. So I guess eventually, you know, I start doing that, and they start adding up, and I went to Columbia, and that's a school with about 10,000 other producers there at the same time. So it was like, damn, okay, it's a lot of, you know, I'm right here like, man, I make beats just like y'all. Like, what's going to really separate mine? Even though I believed in myself, you know, but at the same time, while going there, it wasn't really that many male singers. One, you know, everybody was rapping, and everybody could, you know, at least make it sound like they can rap. But can nobody really, I can't even say sing, but have music in which people would be willing to purchase, you know what I'm saying, many artists as there were at Columbia. So I think that was my change when I decided, you know, to stop, you know, rapping, start singing, which is my singing style. You know, is like singing rapping, because most of my songs are like, you know, words with melody. Rap
shout
with
out
melody,
to Nate
Dogg.
No.
So I can't say I can sing, you know, Usher or Stevie out the water, but I definitely could, you know, just not know how to create a record. So
let me ask you this, Dream. Let me ask you this question.
What
can we look forward to your second album, All About You? Give us an insight. What can we look forward to? Give me a reason why I should go out and purchase this album.
Man, I'm talking about song by song, you know. Unfortunately, with this album, they only allowed, you know, as far as business-wise, 11, 12 tracks due to publishing. But I guarantee you every song is well worth every bit of a listen. I think it's going to showcase a lot of growth for me. I mean, I don't know if you even really had my first album, but definitely with this album, I think it's going to show that type of growth vocally. It's no more none of those tones. I feel like I was just playing with the first album, but this one, I knew what it was. I know that I'm a signed artist. I feel like I know what the people want to hear. I got something for the ladies for the bedroom. I got something for the thugs in the club. I got something for your moms to step to. I just feel like it's an overall piece of work that I feel like, you know, everybody in somehow, some way can relate to. So I'm definitely looking forward to people in here. Like I say, everybody can just hit it. I hate sometimes when they put a single out and to me it doesn't define the album, but I think that's just what the people want to hear.
So your song I Like, it defines your album?
Not at all. You know what, I Like, that record was chose by LA, because once I came to LA with the new music, he was like, man, I really don't know, you know, I couldn't tell him what I felt the single was, because I felt everyone could be a single in its own format.
LA Reid,
you know,
right? LA Reid or LA the city?
LA Reid.
Oh, you just said LA. Yeah, I mean.
Well, he's not that.
LA, I'm not on his first name basis.
LA Simon, you know, LA Simon. So he actually chose that record as the first single, and I was just like, you're right, because I felt, you know, it's the type of song when people heard, I was hoping that they know exactly who it was. You know what I'm saying? So I know other records of mine on there, you might be able to not get the hints of who it is, but I think after you hear it and you get to know my voice, then I'm sure you all will get the grasp of it. But I Like was the record. I wanted to get more people back familiar with my sound. And I know people might say, oh, it sounds like this or it sounds like that, but it sounds like me. So, you know, I just felt like that was my point with that record.
Jeremiah, are you on Twitter? And what's your real Twitter for your fans out there that want to follow you?
Well, my real name is Jeremiah without an A. So I know I heard y'all saying Jeremiah a couple times, but it's just Jeremiah.
Hey, my GED don't cover personal names.
So just know at the end. Jeremiah, also I want to let everybody know, if they're in the Los Angeles area, Jeremiah will be performing this Monday.
Monday.
Live at Conga Room, downtown LA.
Hey, Jeff, it's a tough room, man. These LA crowds, they looking for the best, you know what I'm saying? We just had Tweet.
Album release party.
He having an album release party down there?
Yeah, we're doing his album release party, so we'll get to hear a lot of cuts. We're doing your album release party.
Oh, I thought you just said Tweet.
Tweet performed last Monday.
Oh, okay.
So at your album release party, you got some loose bitches down there. That's what we say.
Oh, man, you know what I mean.
Hey, I can say bitch on here.
No, you can't.
Well, we got the new single, so can you bring that on for us?
You check it out right here. This is my new single featuring my main man, Ludacris. Def Jam is definitely in the building. Chi-Town is up in here. This is my first single off my sophomore album, All About You. Y'all check it out. It's called I Like.
Thank you, Jeremiah.
Thank you for the phone call, brother.
Jeremiah without an A.
A Chicago legend.
Let's check it out.
Eddie Long's new ringtone.
Foxhole Countdown.
Oh, yeah. That was nice.
Jeremiah.
That's baby making music. It's very sexy. The ladies like the song. That's what it's supposed to do.
I like the eye.
Well, like baby catching.
I can roll. I can roll on that.
That's
song.
A sexy song. You like baby batter.
Yeah, I like to sprinkle a little
something. I think it's sexy. And I
little clam chowder.
Support him on Monday at the Conga Room. Album release party.
Album release party, yes.
Baby.
I don't know nothing.
What else you got for us, Lou Dix?
Hey,
you know. What else you got for us, Lou Dix?
This
nigga just terrible.
He is so funny.
What's his first name again,
Joe? Beamer.
What's his first name?
Suck a lot of dick.
Bishop.
Suck a lot of dick.
Go ahead, Lou Dick.
How you spell that? Is it W sound?
Suck a lot of.
Can I ask you a question, Lou?
One day.
Yeah, sure. What's up,
Johnny? I'm telling you.
When you dye your hair black, why you don't do your chest hair?
Because he's using those to put in.
You look like a two-tone Broham.
It only come in 4 ounces.
Louis, don't let them do you like that.
No, it's a two-tone Broham.
Louis, channel.
Like 73 Fleetwood. It's the limited edition.
Louis, channel Lou Dix from 87 and kill these dudes.
I'm artistic. That's
no, you are.
Well, put your helmet on.
He's artistic.
You're autistic.
That's fine. I don't mind. I'm aging well. I mean, Speedy, you guys cover your stuff.
You do look good for 60. You do.
60, that's cool.
it's good. You're in good shape.
Oh, that's cool. Hello to all the great Fox.
I used to work for Sherlock Holmes. That's how.
So when you color your, you don't color your hair because you color your scalp.
Does it come in a can?
No.
Can you come in a can?
Speaking of coming in a can, it's Tommy Lee's birthday.
Hello to all the great Fox.
Y'all are absolutely hysterical. Speaking of Aya, it's Indy Iree's birthday as well.
Johnny, what's his first name?
Suck a lot of dick.
Go ahead, Lou Dick. Lou Dick. This is all the reasons right here. You get a great BMW Reese.
Hello.
Two-tone, bro.
Hello to all the great Foxhole listeners out there. I'm Louis Dix, and I would love to let you all know that the Foxhole crew is the Foxhole crew is rolling out on tour. We're so excited.
We are.
Yes, I'm going to be wearing hats. But listen, the BMW of North America is part of the Foxhole family, and because of that, we get to drive the BMW 5 Series Gran Turismo. And, you know, the cool thing is our listeners can still keep in touch with us.
Can they really? How's
yes, they can.
Losers?
They can email, BlackBerry, Facebook, everything.
Yeah.
Have one of Speedy's kids from the neighborhood of the states we go to say hello.
Wow.
Is that my daddy with the foxhole? Make him stop. Why won't you love me?
Hold me, daddy.
Why don't you call?
Daddy, you gonna visit me on Facebook?
It's in your car.
549. Listen, you can get your emails. Yeah. Plenty of room for the Foxhole crew. Thanks. Thanks, BMW of North America.
Things you hear from Louis Dix. Is it a breeze in here?
I also want to thank Bud Light with superior drinkability, that just right taste, not too heavy, not too light. Let's click our bottles, Johnny.
Right?
There we go. A toast to Bud Light.
I bet it's easy for you to get brainwashed.
Only got one layer to get through.
They don't need the X-ray or nothing.
Shouts out to the spin cycle.
not too light. The unique ability
you're
to elevate
sleepy.
Good times.
Yeah.
He's got a lot on his mind.
You never need a CAT scan every time. Like, yeah, you got it.
Bud Light is fun, social, and a perfect beer for bringing people together.
It goes
together.
Great with fish.
Like the Fox. So Bud Light's drinkability, that just right taste. Not too heavy, not too light, and it is elevating some good times up in this piece.
Louis, right? Right. Yes.
Louis, is that you? Is that your Bud Light in a glass?
Yeah.
Look at Louis's ring.
Claudia.
Looks like a.
I was just thinking, I saw your cat on the menu over
Johnny
in Crenshaw and Slauson.
Really wait. Johnny Mac likes his Bud Light on ice.
That's right. Let him finish.
But. That just right taste, not too heavy, not too
I'm gonna be honest, Peter. I steal cases of a Bud Light Lime when a king and somebody ain't looking.
Fuck,
because you know I work sometimes. I come in late at night.
I got one question to ask you,
I give me a couple of cases.
I got one question,
Johnny
Mac. John, I got one question to ask.
What's good?
What's his first name?
Suck a lot of dick.
It's the shirt side of a good time. The just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
And make sure we catch my man down at the spot. Where's he gonna be?
Be sure we check. We are gonna be there, of course. Yeah, Jeremiah's gonna be at Foxhole Live at Conga Room downtown LA this Monday, October 4th.
That's right. Prepare for your name to get pronounced wrong by Mark
He'll
Curry.
Be in our city. What's the next topic, Paul? Let's go to something else.
I'm
tired of Ed Along.
There's some funny stories out there. Yeah, I'll throw it to Claudia.
Oh, well, there's that one.
She said,
hold on. We'll
in medical model news,
you know
she has to log on first. Claudia has to log
there
on
was
first.
A disturbing story in the news this week.
The football player one?
Yeah, well, no, the one.
Oh, the one that committed suicide.
Rutgers. The guy that committed suicide.
So apparently there was a boy that was having a homosexual relationship.
What?
And his roommate installed a camera in the closet. Well, they live streamed it, and everybody saw.
Well, not everybody. A lot of people saw it. And this guy went and jumped off a bridge. And he also, before he did it, he put his Facebook status. He said, I'm sorry, I'm jumping off the George Washington Bridge.
Mm.
The George Washington Bridge?
Now, where do we go
so
from there?
So the question is,
was he successful?
Is that going too far? Should his Lewis roommate be prosecuted?
Well, they're being brought up on charges now.
For what?
Because it did cause him to...
Cyberbullying is what it's called.
Yeah, he's 18, and I guess his parents didn't know if he was a homosexual or something.
But that's not the point. Whether you're gay or not, imagine someone installing a camera in your house and catching what you do in your private time. Louis Dix, Speedy, TDP, Johnny Mac, Poetess, myself.
So a performer and all that, I'm a musician. So in this album, I definitely want to showcase, you know, more of that side of me, more of a different type of soul side of me that maybe the
rap should go where you
not want that to happen.
Put a camera in there and see what happens.
What's gonna happen, John?
I got more farm animals than Noah.
it'd be a lot of amateur videos going on.
Hey, but you know what?
What the hell?
But here's my thing. Here's my take on that.
What is it, Johnny?
Here's my take on that. That's why I access when somebody can take a videotape or a picture of me or whatever and put it up there against my will. This cat, this guy, it cost him his life. The embarrassment and the shame cost. I don't know who runs the internet or the YouTube or he's streamlining. I don't know who runs that.
A dude named YouTube.
But you should be able to get permission from me.
Well,
if you're putting a picture of me on the internet or whatever you want to call it on YouTube, if you're putting a video of me on YouTube, I should be able to give you my permission because look what happened.
It's too out of control.
It's for shock value. Yeah,
but listen, what I'm saying, look what happened. You have cost this kid his life.
877-2106-106 is the number to call it.
That's not funny.
There's a lot of this going on. This is something I've definitely done.
Listen, what I'm saying.
In my life a lot where people take a picture, take it out of context.
Oh, you take your own
picture. I do, and I had to take a lot of pictures down from my Facebook and MySpace of people. But like just innocent posing with maybe someone like you or whatever, and people want to put a rumor to it. But I'm saying a simple picture with the right caption or the wrong caption can ruin your reputation. It could do irreparable damage to your reputation. And then once people see it online and it gets in a newspaper or a blog, people tend to believe that stuff.
Okay, Claudia, you just had a picture of you at the pool.
I did.
So how would a caption of that one picture?
Well, that's an innocent picture, but okay, I used to work on a sports show, and then we joke about me dating ball players, although it hasn't been since 2008.
No, it's true.
Since 2008, I dated someone for a year that played football. But I'm just saying, a long time ago when I was proposed to,
you
should have
went with
Lamar. But I haven't been with a lot of people like that. But I'm just saying, we're getting off track.
Yeah, we're getting
people
off
take
the,
a picture,
the story.
People take a picture, and they can add anything to it, or they can manipulate it, or they can, you know, exploit someone like this kid was exploited for their own enjoyment, because it's funny to poke fun at this guy. And you don't know what this is doing to someone in their personal life. Like, you know, we joke about things, but not everybody can take a joke like that. Right. And not everybody can, you know, afford that.
That was a terrible joke. That's not a joke.
That's not a joke. That's whoever
he
these
thought it was.
And you know what? I agree that the law should press charges against these cats that unbeknownst to this guy Tyler that put this camera and streamlined or put it on whatever his sexual escapade. That's not cool. What makes you think that is funny?
Well, Denton, you know there's a movie coming out.
I don't
like
think it was
that.
About being funny, though. Yeah, I'm trying to out him.
Why am I outing this guy?
Well, because these kids are these.
I hope them motherfuckers get life in prison.
Yeah, these little privileged kids had never had anybody step to them. See, I think we're moving from where we're not demanding that kids or young people.
Who have you ever stepped to? I know you get your ass whooped. I'm tired of you talking about how many people you going to step to. You ain't stepping to nobody.
And do you monitor your kids' online
Yes, I do.
Activity?
Yes, I do.
What?
And
how
yes.
do you monitor?
Well, I monitor by we have Spy. So what? Where we can pull up all of their history.
Oh, good. Good for you.
Whatever they're on
do you
the
know
internet.
How to pull it up?
No, but the thing...
Oh, my God.
Well, your son got to pull up his history.
Hey, turn this on.
Show me how to work this thing.
Okay.
Here.
Plug it in. What are you saying? You spy on your children?
No, well, it's a program called Spy.
It's a program called Spy. See, the thing when I look at with my
explain
kids,
what it is, because some people don't know
what it is. What it is that there's a program you have on your computer, so whenever your kids are on the computer, you can pull up their history. Of
everything
they've
done.
We've had it forever.
The history of websites.
So we've had it forever.
So you actually can't pull up where they've been. You said where they've been.
Where
they've been online.
Okay. What websites they've visited.
Right, okay, where they've been at online.
Yeah, and
what websites and the porn
and emails and their instant messages and all that. Yeah, my son crashed my computer because of his pornographic stuff.
Do you believe your son and your daughter have a right to privacy also? I know you're supposed to supervise them, but they should or should not do.
I think they have a right to privacy. My job is not... let
let them know that I'm peeking into their privacy.
Right.
Now, because you that's found my porn, your son was looking at porn.
Oh yeah.
And what's wrong with that?
Did he look at some stuff that you liked? That you didn't know about. I'm just saying that you didn't know about.
You know what?
What kind of stuff did you look at?
How long did you look at it?
Onion booty.
What I explained to him, I sat there and had him delete it because what I explained to him, it was nasty stuff.
Was it basic stuff like normal?
It was
tops or bottoms.
It was intercourse. It was intercourse.
But just like regular male female sex.
I'm opposed to
you're opposed
to the YouTube and all the internet.
Yeah, it was male female sex.
It was intercourse.
Female female. It was intercourse.
He said female on female.
He had female, female, and then male, male, and then I explained to him that
male,
we had...
Male, male.
No,
don't
male, male.
Don't run by that. You said it.
No, I didn't. He had...
Yes, he
you
did.
You did say male, male.
He actually had... No, what my son had was male, female, and female, female. No, my son is far from...
Hey, that's enough with the cats.
But what happened was I explained to him that we have females in the home, and you cannot have that stuff... And
go in the garage.
You can't, right. No, you just can't. You have to.
Well, what else are you going to jerk off to?
I gave him magazines.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Wait a minute.
Yeah, Black Girls. You gave him Jet.
No, I gave him that.
Hey, you know what,
the ones that come in plastic.
You know what, Lou Diggs? I respect that.
Hysterical.
You're all supposed to monitor and watch what your child do. I respect that.
Good job, LD.
You know what I'm saying? But you know the child, your son is what, 15, 16?
No, say he's 18 now.
Oh, he should be able to.
He's still in high school?
He should be fucking by now.
Oh, yeah. He got a big bottle of Vaseline.
We got a phone call from Houston. We have Leisha.
It's
Misha,
M-I-S-H-A.
Okay, I'm sorry. Sweetheart.
Oh, Johnny Mac, you're terrible today.
Hey, I just read what's wrote.
You just read what's wrote?
Okay. He's messed up it too, so it don't even matter. But I love you guys, though. I have a comment about that, about the guy committing suicide. Like, I think that's very fucked up how they invaded this man's privacy while he was having sex. Like, what if someone was to do that to them and they commit suicide, jump off a building, and their parents are left to moan and they don't have anything left of this young man?
From Houston.
Hi, Alicia.
What's up, Leisha?
Not a Leisha.
No, it's Leisha with an L.
Yeah, the L is silent.
So it's a W.
No, it's no W. You know what I'm saying? That's fucked up.
Yes, sir.
What should happen? What should be the punishment?
Prison.
I think they deserve life in jail.
Me too.
I do.
Why?
I think they deserve life.
Because
why would you do that? No, even that, even him killing himself, that is still so, like, disrespectful to invade someone's privacy. He asked for privacy. You should have gave him that. Don't put no secret fucking camera in my house to see what I'm doing. Is you serious? I could be fucking six different bitches or fucking six different niggas. We're like, what the fuck would that have to do with you?
I hate when that gets out.
Hey, give us your email. We want to check you out.
No, she had a point, though.
Thank you for the phone call.
Let you do you. And, you know what I'm saying? Like, people, they obviously had bad intentions.
Everybody's trying to come up, no matter what it is.
Right,
and I think they thought this was going to be their little come up tape. Like, didn't
YouTube,
know it was going to go to the left.
And it wasn't actually a tape. It was live stream.
Well, I mean, they thought it was going to be
something. But can I switch up the story now?
Yeah, because I had a great one, too.
Well, hold on for a second.
You want to change subject to me? Or?
Can we change subject?
Hold on for a second.
Can we jump off this bridge?
What about the lady with the Mexican maid? Said it wasn't. She had,
Meg Whitman.
Meg Whitman.
What's up with that lady?
What about, what's wrong, Johnny?
What's wrong, John?
I like that topic.
Oh, but he could turn to this. Hey, we're on
the air. I don't know what's going on.
Hilarious.
I think this topic, like, the internet is super, super popular now. Like, right. Almost everybody has an email address. Everybody has internet access now. It's very popular. And with Twitter and social media and all this thing, everything, it's so fast. If you really have malice against one person, you can destroy someone's reputation and drive someone nuts within a week.
But how was that?
It's illegal what they're doing. They're going
to
get charged.
That's what I'm trying to get. This is tragic.
It's awful. But think about
something that that we should learn
from. We're probably going to see a lot of cyberbullying laws because this isn't the first time that a suicide has been committed as a result of someone.
Wasn't that a MySpace case like that?
The mother, the cheerleader, the mother posed as some boy that she liked, and the cheerleader ended up committing suicide because the boy told her he didn't like her anymore. And all along, it was
the mom.
A mother.
And there's plenty of people that don't go that far to commit suicide, but that are in deep depressions, that are embarrassed, that don't want to go to school, that don't want to show their faces.
Right.
I know, like I said, I'm sure we've all had things written about us on the internet.
Right.
And it's like, it doesn't feel good, especially when you know
we have to. And I know we're supposed to have our First Amendment, freedom of speech, freedom of assembly. But all that's supposed to be for the right thing. for me, I should not have the freedom to put, I don't know, what's the word I'm looking for, malice or thing that's
ill intention,
thing that's can hurt and corrupt or kill. I should not have the right to put these things, like you say, the Facebook incident and this streamlining this. I don't have the right to cause someone else pain and suffering. I don't have that right.
Right.
This child now,
they thought it was
is 19 years old. My
it wasn't
man,
a joke.
My man,
it was
this person
intent.
Is dead.
That's you got to know that that's going to break someone's heart.
He didn't know that
this
was going
to happen.
This person
is dead.
But you got to know.
With another dude.
That's why you don't do it. If my, whatever this guy is doing, whatever this person is doing behind closed doors is supposed to remain behind. Who gives you the right to bring what I'm doing behind closed doors to the front?
Right.
If I'm not doing anything criminal, and if I'm doing something criminal, that's something different. But this guy is doing nothing. He's bothering nobody.
Right. Well,
him and whoever he was with, who gives you the right? This guy's dead now.
He's dead. A young 18 years old.
This guy is dead for the embarrassment and shame that you caused him, and you thought it was funny to put a camera in his room and videotape. This guy is dead.
Yeah, it's obvious, though. He evidently had some issues. I know he was a great musician, they said, and he was really gifted.
What, he played the flute?
I'm not sure the violin. He played the violin. And then the thing that you notice is that sometimes these young people right now are so fragile. You know, because they just have nothing to hold on to. They have no substance.
No backbone.
Yeah, and where we, you know, our parents always told us. I mean, you tell a kid nowadays, I brought you in this world, I'll take you out. They're going to have to get some therapy. I mean, we heard that all the time. So I just think their skin, it's a little thinner.
Well, with the technology, it's easier to be embarrassed on a national level. As before, if you have rumors about somebody being gay or whatever, it's a rumor. You don't really have proof. Now you can put someone totally on blast, whether
worldwide,
you're telling the truth or not.
Yeah.
And it's like, and that's humiliating.
Right. What you guys do? Totally agree with that.
We have a phone call from North Carolina.
Take your time.
Lindsay, he's a male. Lindsay from North Carolina. What's up, Lindsay?
Here you go, Johnny.
Lindsay,
what's going on, Sasha? How y'all doing?
What's going on, brother?
Hey.
First and foremost, got mad love for you guys. First time listener, first time caller.
Thank you, brother.
Just wanted to say it should be a matter of that's just messed up because. I mean, if they had to come in front of a court of law, which they need to, they should be up for a premeditated murder because they didn't put that camera in that boy's room was premeditated because it was for no good reason, you know?
Right.
And, you know, like you said, a family lost their son over some stupid stuff that got put out on video. And, I mean, y'all in the entertainment industry, y'all understand more than anybody. Sometimes you do not want stuff that y'all do put out there like that. It's not cool.
That's true.
I mean, even for y'all, you know, even with y'all being in the industry, being at the level y'all are, y'all fighting every single day to keep stuff that you don't want put out there. And it should be the same for the humans. It should be the same for the normal Joe. There's a lot of stuff that I don't want put out there or anybody else put out there. But it's nobody's right to be putting someone's camera in your room and putting this out on blast just to hurt somebody's feelings.
You're right, man.
Yeah, Lindsay, you're right.
You
so, Lindsay, what do you have you don't want put out there?
Your name?
Have any of you guys ever had like something that came out on you?
Thank you for the phone call, man.
You didn't, you know, appreciate or you didn't co-sign or you didn't want out there, like maybe with the internet? Anybody?
No.
Well, you tell us because you're always on it.
You tweet all the time.
We don't get it.
I do tweet a lot, but I know that because, okay, well, we choose to do as a living. We kind of put ourselves out there. We're in that position.
But isn't that the gift and curse?
It is the gift and curse. Like, I recently have this blogger that's been going hard on me ever since my breakup, and it's been really awful stuff calling me a homewrecker and saying all these kind of things that are not true that I've been with.
So you go look at it.
Well, I told my friends to not ever send me anything anymore, but sometimes, like, I'll get a random phone call from a relative that'll say, I read this about you online, and it's awful, awful stuff, and it's not true.
Right.
And it's like, this is damaging stuff because all it takes is one person to take that and put it in a newspaper. Once it's in a newspaper, it's deemed as fact.
I don't think it's going to get that far.
No, it has, though. I've had stuff in newspapers.
Yeah. Oh, okay. You know what? That you're true, because I did that. One time, my son was messing around. He pulled up the little Facebook stuff.
Yeah.
And he's like... Well, Facebook, whatever.
So
he's like,
just on a calculator. He ain't too good on
No, he's like, Dad, they talking about it. They crack it on you, Dad.
What they say about you on Facebook?
Well, I guess they say some mean things. I didn't look at it.
Well, there's a lot of, when you can be anonymous, you can
and
be
And
there's
some dude, he's like, Dad, this dude must be gay because he always on you. On Facebook. Keyser or whatever. Keyser or whatever his name is.
Like Kenneth.
Yeah, he's always talking about you like he like you, Dad. What's wrong with him? And if an 18-year-old boy says, what's wrong with another man because he's on you too much?
Right.
It's honest.
So did it bother you?
How did that
it bothered me because the simple fact is I don't think I'm that important to where you would actually talk
either.
About me. You
know, neither does your
hair. So, well,
there's
so many other things in your life should be more important.
Hey,
but for you, so I just laugh
even,
at
know
it.
What? I don't even read that stuff. There's so
oh,
many.
I've never read it.
I don't even read that stuff.
No, I haven't read that.
Because if anybody has time to waste sitting at a computer, just purposely being mean and writing mean things about people and telling lies about people, they don't have a life. It's
they
just
don't.
Like, why would I even waste my time on
can
that?
We sue them?
You can sue, and I have talked
to that's freedom of speech.
No.
That's not freedom of
speech.
That's
when it's a lie, I contacted a lawyer because it got really vicious where I had relatives call me saying, oh, I know this isn't true about you, but I've read this about you. I contacted a lawyer. It's very expensive. You can do it, and I think that's why bloggers are so bold. Some of them, there's a lot of good ones out there, but there's some that are just very reckless. They just care about getting you to click on their webpage. They don't care about the truth. It costs you a lot of money, and they know it's a lot of aggravation that most likely you're not going to sue. But I think more celebrities and people that are bothered by this, Louis Dix as well, we should start fighting back.
I don't have any money to sue.
But I'm just saying.
Okay, Claudia, I'll stop.
Please stop.
You're going to stop. I wish them all the best. If they like talking to me, that makes me feel good.
Well, but as long as it doesn't affect your money.
That was kind of creamy.
Yo, we're going to go to Portis and see what she has right now.
Actually, I'm going to throw it to Speedy and see what he has.
Very important.
Speedy, what do you have?
He's going to catch it, too.
he won't.
On the phone.
Yeah, now it looks like a baseball.
On the phone, we have director, producer, has a new movie that's out now called Chain Letter. We got Mr. Deion Taylor on the phone. Deion Taylor.
Yeah. Hey, Deion.
What's going on?
How you guys doing?
What's going on, Deion? What's happening, D?
Man, just traveling, man. Just landed.
No, Fox was on last week, and he was talking about how intense this new movie, Chain Letter, is. Can you give us a little bit about the movie?
Yeah, I would love to. First of all, thank you guys all for having me on. This was an honor and a blessing to be on the radio with you guys.
Thank you.
But yeah, the film is actually, it puts you in the mind of something like Saw and Texas Chainsaw Massacre. The movie has a lot of twists and turns. Actually has a huge twist at the end of the film. Right when you think you figure it out, you get blindsided with some more information. So it's pretty good in that way. And, you know, we've been blessed with getting some really good reviews on the film, which is very hard when you have a horror movie. And, it's knocking them dead right now. We actually sold out in about 7 theaters this morning in New York on the release. And,
wow.
We're getting some heavy competition with the, Facebook social network movie that's out. They got about $100 million in prints and advertising. And, but we're competing.
Now, dear, this is more Speedy because you produced my movie. How hard was it?
Wait, what?
Let me
finish. Yes, Speedy.
Stand up movie.
He had a movie called You Ain't Gonna Make It.
How hard was it to get people to believe that a black director and producer is doing a horror movie?
Well, here's the thing, man. I think you all know this. Like, I'm probably, I am the first person in the space to actually release a crossover urban film as a black director. And it was very hard, man. I've been kind of had to beat the streets in L.A. for about a year and a half, 2 years with the movie. Got involved with some of the people who worked with Twisted Pictures who really saw. We actually parted ways, and then I had to, like, really go get this movie off my own. And, it was hard, man. And we finally did it. We found a really good distributor. And they got this film out, man. And right now we're tracking extremely well. The movie opened nationwide and actually opened domestically and foreign on the same day.
Great, great.
Hey, Deion, it's Claudia here, and I had
the pleasure. Hey, Claudia.
How are you?
Good.
I had the honor of going to the screening and very impressed. It's a very mainstream movie. It's not a black film. It's a mainstream film, and I heard you shot it. Jamie said you shot it in 16 days last week on the show. He said that. Right.
Yeah, we shot. Yeah, that got me in a lot of trouble. We shot the film in 16 days. And the movie's actually, what's amazing about that is that it is shot in 35 millimeters. So it's not like an HD movie where we're running around with cameras. It's a real technical film. And we got really lucky because we ended up getting Nikki Reed, who's the lead in Twilight. And she actually played the lead in this film. And then we got Keith David and Brad Dourif from Aliens. And, the rest was history. So, yeah, it was a 16-day shoot. And about 6 of those days were 20-hour days.
And Deion, I read somewhere that the budget was like $3 million, and it does not look like that. You did an amazing job with that money.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah, we have the budget was a little shy of $3 million, and yeah, you're right. The film has about 25 stunts in it. You know, 34 locations, and it's a That's big a movie. But it was actually my calling card to get this film out, and this is the movie that I think is going to let a lot of people know who Deion Taylor is. And you know, obviously, I've been very blessed to have Jamie involved and Marcus King to even allow me to do this, and I'm just excited, man. And right now, what I really want to promote to everyone that's listening to this show is that if you're around and you see those posters, you see that movie, go support the film. You know, it's not only about me being a black filmmaker with this type of movie, but at the same time, it is about independent filmmakers getting a chance to release.
Right,
and
right. This
food for thought right now, food for thought real fast. This was the only movie independently sold to a major distributor.
His image to go down the drain like that for someone to just slander him in so many different ways and put it on the internet, that's like so fucked up.
Well, you know what? You're young. Let me ask you a question. What do you think?
In the last 2 years.
Wow. Congratulations.
Deion, I had a question for you. You mentioned the movie is like along the lines of Saw and Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Because it looks on camera sometimes.
Yeah, because what happens is sometimes you have to set them on a set to get those type of action sequences. And a lot of times when you're dealing with real, you know, real talent, like I was on this movie, like these people really want to kind of get into the character. They really want to believe that the sets are, you know, really scary or what have you. And a few times what I did was I would just turn off all the lights on the whole movie production. Mm-hmm. And the only thing that would be...
When you're shooting those kind of movies, is it scary to shoot a scary movie? Is like the set scary, and is it a scary...
Tone and the mood on is one light and the camera. So you can get some of the sequences, and, you know, that's really how you shoot horror. It's really allowing people to be in the space and really doing what you could do from a production standpoint to make them feel like they're in that world.
Now, Deion, Speedy again. Tell people out there. We did my stand-up movie, which is going to be coming out really soon. Tell everyone out there how can they go about to go.
This movie is titled "This Shit Is Terrible."
Yeah, how does Speedy's acting compare to the acting on Shane Leto?
I was
Shane
doing
Leto.
Stand-up. Shut up. Let people know how they can find out where the movie's playing at
Chain
in their
letter.
City. Where are we playing in their city? Or how do they find that out? Is there a website they can go to or anything like that?
Yeah, if you go to Chain Letter, you can Google Chain Letter, the movie, and it'll pop up in all the cities that it's playing in. It's actually playing in 700 theaters right now, New York, Chicago, Atlanta, L.A., Miami, Houston. I can't even name all the cities, but it is everyone in the major cities, the movie is there. And I'm sure we've been getting a lot of calls, like I said, from the East Coast and L.A. and Atlanta about the film being, you know, on all the billboards and stuff. So definitely support it. Chainletter.com is the website. And, you know, just support that, man, please.
That's right.
Hey, Deion, how's it doing on the bootleg release?
You know what? Hey, let me tell you something. I got real
lucky. It ain't
going to
break
man.
The phone playing record.
I hope it's tracking well with blacks.
Let me tell you something, man. I got real lucky, man, because my movie, the poster, got a whole bunch of white faces. So they left that alone, man.
Hey, Deion. It's Louis. Louis Dick.
It's going to be something about your father. Get ready.
It's something about your father.
No.
How's your daddy?
No. What I wanted to ask you was...
do you have Bishop Eddie Long's phone number?
Congratulations, but also, where were you born and raised? I mean, nobody knows where he's from. Where are you from? Where were you born and raised? And did you have a family around you? And I mean, how did you... How did you get the fortitude to become Deion Taylor?
His mother was
y'all didn't know that.
Because Rip Taylor was taken.
Listen, man. I was born and raised in Gary, Indiana. So, all my family is still in Gary. Half my family is in Chicago. And then what happened was I ended up playing basketball, and I left Indiana, went to San Diego State, and I moved my mom during that time to Sacramento. So that's kind of how I got to Sacramento.
So you took some of that booster money? How did you get your mom to San Diego, boy?
That's funny, man.
Well, it's a great story, Deion. Congratulations, man.
And we got some other projects that we're doing, right, Deion?
Yeah, we got a bunch of stuff we're doing, man. I'm really excited about the Foxhole Comedy Show, man. I think that's going to be incredible. We just finished cutting the trailer to that. It looks insane. Jamie did a great job. Speedy looks Man, you did a fantastic job, man. Kevin Hart is great.
Speedy looks what?
Claudia, everybody, Louis Dick, everybody did a great job, man.
You know Deon, what, Deon, you're really hurting your brand.
I know that you're a great director. I've seen some of your work in the past, and I respect you. You talk, and you love all my comedy. And with your camera and your directorial eye, is it a possible way that you can make Speedy look slim or even a good actor? Could you cut around the bad acting of Speedy to make him at least as good as Todd Bridges?
Funny.
I'm dead serious.
Well, there's a lot of technology nowadays.
I'm dead serious.
That's funny. You know what? I'll leave that up to Jamie, man. Jamie's doing a good job as a director right now, man. So I'm sure he'll know exactly how to shoot Speedy to make him slim.
Ain't that a
turn the camera off.
That's funny.
But like joking today.
Or really just shoot him. So, Deon, tell about your other endeavors that you have, other things, other films that you'll be working on. What else should we look forward to coming from Mr. Deon Taylor?
Well, right now, man, I've been just really heavy at, you know, working with Jamie a little bit on the No Brainer logo and the banner and pushing that stuff. I think what we got next is the film Terminated, which is a movie, which I think is more like a Hitchcock type film. 15 people board an aircraft from LAX to JFK. And when they land, they're the last people on Earth. That's the next film. And,
wow.
It's a crazy film. Deals with a lot of, just a lot of, you know, puzzle pieces in the movie, and me and Jamie been really heavy into that. And then also, you know, we got the TV stuff that's really going extremely well, and I'm just being supportive with all the things that Jamie and Marcus and the Kings and Foxhole has all put together with to the Fox Sketch Comedy Show. I think that's going to be incredible. It is the new In Living Color. And,
yes,
you know,
did.
Outside of that, man, just developing content. I know we're trying to work on the Kids on the Planet with you, Speedy. What's happening?
Thank you.
That, man?
It's The plane was filled with his kids.
Based on a true story.
Well, Deon, I know there's a lot of projects we've all been talking to. No, I'm just saying we're excited
TDP,
to work with you.
TDP got it. Go ahead, TDP.
Deon Taylor, I just want to congratulate you. Congratulate you on the Chain Letter. And they will push all the traffic to chainletter.com.
Yes.
And as a group here at the Foxhole, Johnny Mac, Lewis, myself, Claudia, we want to put Speedy in the Eddie Bishop Long story. We want you to shoot that. We will play the deacons. Yeah. Claudia will play the first lady.
Who's gonna be the kids?
Poetess will be the kids.
Yeah, what do you think about that project? Can we make that a go?
The great thing is Speedy don't need no stunt guys.
Yeah, no makeup.
He'll do all the sex scenes.
Direct to DVD.
But that DVD gonna have an STD. Hey, you know what, Deon, man?
Funny.
Thanks for the phone call, man. We're gonna get out there and we all gonna support every Foxhole listener, everyone here at the Foxhole. We're gonna go make sure we go check
Chain
out
Letter.
Chain Letter, man. You did a great job. Any parting words you would like to say to us?
No, just thank you very much for the support, you guys, and for all the listeners. You know what? I'm a Foxhole listener as well, and please support the film. Keep supporting these guys. They have done a tremendous job with Foxhole Radio, and I guess we should be saying, look for the DVD of Foxhole Live.
Finally.
The comedy show coming soon, man.
Coming soon.
Finally, really going to happen. People got it, and it's really
And my parting words to Deon Taylor, that when the movie's out, it's going to be a great success. Drinks are on you. All right, we got to take a break. We're going to take a break at the Foxhole. Be right back.
Chain Letter.
Yeah, and I love this song. Usher doing his thing right here.
Yeah,
I hate this song.
I love this song.
Why you hate it?
Why you hate this song?
Because it sounds all. You a hater.
Yeah, it brings out all the slim girls. Brings out all the slim girls.
It's a hot song.
I love this song.
It seems like all the songs are sounding so much alike.
Yeah, right. Voice box on it.
Yes, everything. Take it closer.
That's why y'all gotta listen to some Michael Frank.
Y'all haters.
What?
Michael Frank.
It's Usher right there.
Michael Frank.
You sound like Usher. You sound like Escort.
Monkey see, monkey do.
Hey, you know, we had a great show at the Foxhole. We're going to do a quick, you know, wrap up right quick. Poetess, you got some party words?
Check me out on Twitter, OG Poetess, or on Facebook.
Hey, Thighs.
The Poetess. All right. I just
want to see murder.
I wish everybody a great weekend. I'm going down to Miami to hang with my best friend, Alta. I'm going to go to the Patriots-Miami game.
She got married, right?
Yeah.
It's over already?
I didn't say that.
The way you look.
But we're going to be at the Patriots
Miami
game.
Alta got left at the altar?
Monday Night Football. No, she's still married. Leave her alone.
That was her that left at the altar.
No, actually, I followed through with my wedding, but it's just marriage. last.
Hey, it's all good, Claudia.
Nothing like a good follow through.
We still love you at the Foxhole.
It's cool. It's
That's right.
And you're a great, I don't know what position you play in softball.
I play bench. That gets yelled at.
Well, that's
we need somebody there.
Yeah, yeah. You need somebody on the bench. You can't have a team.
Somebody got to take pictures.
I got y'all covered. Good thing I got a wide.
You had a double and a Twitter at the same time.
I got y'all covered. Bitches.
Yo, my man TDP to play a great first base.
I want to say a shout out to my girl Kelly Ripa because we both share the same birthday. Happy birthday, girl.
When's your birthday today?
Oh, it's just tomorrow.
Happy birthday.
Yeah. I'm on the deuce.
Are you going to get some birthday?
Me and my girl Kelly. Girl, you know
Happy birthday, TDP.
Happy birthday, TDP.
You have a birthday mess.
I bought you a gift. I bought you two shirts. You might want to wear them at the same time.
Yeah,
but,
he will.
Cheryl Miller built mother.
Any special plans, TDP?
Yeah, what are you doing, T?
I do what I want to
like
do.
Cheryl Miller.
That wasn't that funny.
TDP was getting down at Speedy's birthday party. He was getting down.
Yeah, he had his little hat on.
I was in rare mode that night.
Yeah, I got pictures.
Yeah, he thought it was
good. Well, Special Ed and Digital Underground is performing Saturday. Speedy's hosting special birthday party for Ricky Harris.
Not this week. I think you got to host.
At CineSpace.
I was going to ask you to host.
They got some money for
me? How about me?
They paid me?
All right, then I will host. Speedy, Saturday. Let's do this.
Speedy, you got some parting words?
Yes, I will be in Oakland, California this week with my man, Rodman, Joe Claire, and Lester Berry. We're going to be at the Kaiser Center, right there.
That's a great theater.
Yes, that's a nice theater.
Yes, it is.
We'll be there this Saturday.
Was that 5,000?
No. The smaller.
The 2,500.
No.
Oh, you're doing a room at the
Kaiser? No, it's the Kaiser Roll.
The closet.
Oh, okay. No, they got a little balcony. It's a nice little
anyway, it's a nice little thing. It sold about 300.
Good job, Speedy.
Nice. It's nice. Anyway, and also, too, I'll be in Atlanta.
All y'all, and it's only 300?
I'll be in Atlanta.
I had 300 for me, myself.
I'll be in Atlanta Tuesday. I won't be here Wednesday. I'll be there Tuesday and Wednesday because I got to go down because we're going to be in Atlanta as the whole team. We're going to be down there.
What team?
You're going down to, you're performing at Lenox Mall?
I'm going to Eddie Long's church Sunday.
Bring your 10% in a condo.
So definitely check it out. Hit me on my Facebook, which is Mr. Speedy Caldwell.
Okay.
I was going to use it.
You know what's crazy, Speedy? You really think you are important in other people's lives, don't you? Mr. Speedy Caldwell. Nigga, nobody want to hear that shit.
Oh, my God.
My son is here.
He is.
He's right next to me.
Who gives a fuck?
Your son is so cute.
Your son is
so
cute. Shout out to the mama.
How old are you?
He's 6. He got his first haircut.
10 more years.
Yeah.
What the hell?
Claudia. Hey, Speedy, she still be in the club. Don't worry about it.
I will. Oh. I sure will.
Lou Dix, what you got to say?
What's your first name?
Sagalala. Listen, shout out to, I'll be heading to
I'll
my son's
headed.
Game.
I'll be. You've been getting headed.
I'll be headed to my son's game in a couple hours. He's playing Alameda. Harvard Westlake is playing them.
What position?
He's playing wide receiver, number 3. I asked him to catch 4 touchdown passes.
Number
he said he would.
Field,
and what are you wearing? And what are you wearing today?
Today I'm wearing my Michael Vick jersey that was sent to me by my second mom in Philly. She was at the show, and they also sent me some Tasty Cake.
Your first mom quit?
No.
You can have a baby.
I'm done. I'm done.
You can have
a baby. Ain't gonna be shit.
You got this.
His he mustache. Got hair on his thigh.
Hey, Lou Dix, did your son play a game in the Valley? Yes, it's off the 405. What they're playing at today? Yeah, off the 405. You know what? What time? It's at 7:00. I'ma show up, Lou Dix. For real. I'm dead serious.
Oh, cool. I'm going to go to a game your dad's going to be at. I got to meet the crackhead.
That's when the San Antonio Slaves play.
There's going to be a lot of crack at that game.
Shout out to my dad. He's listening to the show. He want me to tell you all hi.
What's up, Mr.
Dix? I bet he does want to say hi.
I played 18 holes of golf with Lewis' father and Asterica.
Johnny, what's Lewis's dad's first name?
Suck a lot.
No, I think he's smoking a lot.
Senior.
Suck a lot of senior.
Smoke a lot.
I love you,
Dad. What are you doing, Johnny, man?
Yeah, what are you doing?
It must be something because you want us to know.
I don't really
You don't wash your clothes because your shirt dirty.
Wow. First of all, this shirt is brand new. This t-shirt is from Bloomingdale.
Somebody lied.
This shirt cost me $46. It's a t-shirt.
You paid
now, how much did this shirt cost?
You said Bloomingdale's or Howie Mandel?
You paid
paid $46 for a T-shirt?
I did, Lou. Did.
He know he did. Don't believe
that's
that.
That's ridiculous.
Don't believe that, Lou.
I get five T-shirts for
$10. He got a pocket on his
but
shirt.
Your shirt's already got a stain on it. Hey, yo, you know, shout out to my boy Jamie Foxx. He's out on the road right now working.
Fun
He's
show.
Doing his thing. Shout out to my man Marcus King. He's out on the road working and doing his thing. You know, so everybody's doing their thing, and we appreciate everybody at the Foxhole. Make sure that you look on. I use moviemojo.com to find out where the movie's going to be at.
There you go.
And look up Chain Letter.
Yes. And check
it out. It's a great. It's a great experience to see this movie, what this guy did in 16 days, with the amount of money that he had and the amount of time that he had.
Right.
It's a great experience. You got to check it out.
Johnny Mac, tell them to make sure they check their tickets, because they try to play the brothers like that.
We're going to put positive spin on this right here. Positive. We're going to think positive. We ain't had Bishop Eddie Long's church. Make sure you go check out Chain Letter. Trust me. Treat yourself this weekend. Lou Dix, I'm going to come see your son play football. Then after that, I'm not going to go with you. I'm going to find out where you can find this movie at. It's a great experience, man. Make sure you check it out.
Girl,
it's the Foxhole, Series 106, XM 149. We out of here.
Great weekend, everybody.
Yes.
Love you.